now these two arch rivals.
For the one flyweight world championship. Fighting out of Japan, the challenger, Yuya Wakamatsu. From Brazil, the undisputed one flyweight champion of the world, Adriano Moraes.
Submission specialist versus knockout artist.
In a special rules super fight. From the USA, Demetrious.
Fighting goes down tonight.
For the one Atomweight World Championship. From Thailand, the challenger, Stamp Fairtex. Representing the USA and Singapore.
Waiting for
tonight, you will see true warrior spirit as the heroes of one championship battle for honor, respect, and glory. Tonight, we celebrate 10 years of history with a special moment and a incredible fight that have made us the home of martial arts. Tonight, we are one.
The 1X Grand Finale kicks off as Superborn defends the featherweight kickboxing championship of the world against the man who knocked him out in 28 seconds when they last met, the great Marat Gregorian. For the inaugural featherweight championship of the world. Oh, good night, Irene!
Superborn is a featherweight kickboxing world champion. The best kickboxers on the planet in the greatest kickboxing tournament. And the Grand Prix winner gets a shot at Superborn. Marat Gregorian, the favorite to win the GP, is out.
When I test positive, I was just disappointed about that I'm out of the Grand Prix tournament. I was ready, I was sharp.
I don't want to wear the winner. I want Marat, I want Rivan.
Last time I knocked him out in 28 seconds.
And he broke me. 4 years already. I have to fix this.
I'm coming for you. I want to see the fear in his eyes.
I want to be the bit, on top to everyone.
I don't care what he's thinking. I want the belt.
You remember last time I do to Petrosian?
Giorgio Petrosian is out cold!
Do you have to do more than that?
Just to surprise him, I want to knock out Superborn with a kick.
You're not good at that. You have only the punching. You can do that before? Never, right? And how are you gonna do to me?
I want to see him down. That's it.
That cannot happen.
This is a match made by the kickboxing gods.
I'm coming to beat you with another ice cold KO.
Perfectly placed. That's Marat Gregorian.
I knock out Marat and Andre Hussein. I am the number one.
Set for what should be an absolute classic. The Featherweight Kickboxing World Championship. A rematch. The entire kickboxing world has been waiting for. And there he is, Marat Gregorian, the challenger. And what a challenger. Last time he fought Superborn, he knocked out Superborn in 28 seconds. He said, I'm going to do it again. I'm going to knock Superbon out cold. I'm going to take the championship belt from the Thai. Superbon laughed at him. Gregorian said, just you wait and see. That familiar music. And look at this sellout crowd inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. All right, Gregorian. No smiles, no waving. It's all business for Marat. Can he knock out Superbon again? Can he claim the one Super Series featherweight kickboxing world title? It will need to be something special because the Superbon of 2022, who comes off a knockout of Giorgio Petrosian, is not the same Superbon Marin Gregorian knocked out years ago. The Superbon of today is a whole different breed of animal. But that said, so too, Dragon, is Marek Gregorian.
Yeah, 100%. Marat Gregorian has looked so good as of late. His high-volume approach has led to 38 career knockouts. And like you said, he was the last person to beat Superbon in less than 30 seconds. This multi-time world champion puts a pace on his opponents and hunts them down like he's looking for his next meal. Marat Gregorian is so much fun to watch because he is all out aggression. He's got serious power carried in those gloves of his, but what he also has is some speed and power inside those kicks. Marat says he wants to push the pace for all five rounds or until Superbon falls. I can't believe we're kicking off the grand finale with this fight.
Marat Gregorian, who ruthlessly retired the great Andy Sauer in his last match with a dominant TKO. Ultra aggressive, but also technical Marat Gregorian. A KO machine, a pair of impressive KOs to kick off his one career. Also, Giorgio Petrosian is a good friend of his. Says he wants to get some payback on behalf of Petrosian, who Superbon knocked out cold in one of the all-time great kickboxing knockouts. The three-punch combo that had Superbon out cold against the ropes in 28 seconds was something extraordinary. Will it be repeats or will it be revenge tonight? Winning the one belt would be the crowning achievement of Marat Gregorian's decorated career. And my word, does he look ready. Rest in peace, Taylor Hawkins. I get chills when I see this man. The Mong Kong around the head in the Thai colors. The belt over the shoulder of the man who, after he KO'd Giorgio Petrosian, is now regarded, full stop, no argument, as the number one pound-for-pound kickboxer in the world. He is on a great tear and a three-fight streak against Sitichai, Petrosian, and Gregorian tonight would be considered one of the great kickboxing win streaks. Superbon has promised to knock Gregorian out just like he knocked out Petrosian. He asked for Gregorian for his first world title defense. Once he learned Gregorian was available for 1X after pulling out of the one featherweight kickboxing World Grand Prix semi-final in February due to illness. And there he is. They call him the current Boorcat. He speaks fluent English. His technique is amazing. Can he pull off one of those head kick knockouts tonight against his arch enemy, Marat Gregorian? You see the Sumi belt case and the brand new one championship belt in the background. Who will take home the belt? The journey continues with Toomey. The final blessing, the removal of the Moncon. If we were in a ring, it would be placed on a corner post. Superbon looking in tremendous shape. Mitch, this has all the makings of a kickboxing classic.
Yeah, Superbon coming off of that knockout of Giorgio Petrosian. He's currently riding an 11-fight win streak, and he has just gotten better and better. This guy is really something special, and he's another one of those Muay Thai artists who has perfectly adapted his game to kickboxing. Now, he has fully committed to kickboxing, and we have seen just him grow and develop so well inside this sport. He is so aggressive. His kicks are so powerful and smooth. Really something magical to watch.
With the Petrosian knockout, he prophesied it on social media. He showed the technique for weeks that he used to knock out Petrosian. In the lead up to this one, we've seen him throw a jumping side kick on social media in his training. Imagine that. Imagine knocking out Gregorian with a jumping flying side kick. Here's how they match up in our tail of the tape for the Featherweight Kickboxing Championship of the World. Superbon gives up the reach by 3 centimeters, has the height by 1. 3 judges circle side are scoring on a 10-point must system. It is 5 rounds for a championship fight. To meet our athletes, let's go to Don Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the home of martial arts, One Championship! Live from Singapore and broadcast to over 150 countries, this is One X! And now, ladies and gentlemen, we begin with 5 rounds of 3 minutes for the One Featherweight Kickboxing Championship of the World! Introducing first, out of the blue corner, he is the number one featherweight kickboxing contender and a 3-time glory kickboxing world champion, standing at 176 centimeters tall, weighing in at 153 pounds, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 65 wins and 11 losses. Training out of Hammer's Gym, representing Armenia! Introducing his opponent out of the red corner. He stands at 177 centimeters tall, weighing in at 153 pounds, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 112 wins and 34 losses. Training out of Singa Mawin Muay Thai, representing Thailand. He is the reigning and defending undisputed One Featherweight Kickboxing Champion of the World, Superbon! And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Olivier Coste.
All right, guys, watch out for the headbutt. Low blow and back of the head. You both know the rules. Fight fair, fight clean. Touch grab if you want. Back of your corner.
Final instructions from the boss, Olivier Coste. Sold out inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium as 1X gets underway.
Back. All right, judge, time. Ready? Choke!
The One Super Series Featherweight Kickboxing World Title. Superbon, the champion, seeking revenge. Gregorian, the challenger, seeking the gold. Frankie Gurley from Superbon. In the white and red. Nice stiff jab from the champ. Outside leg kick from Superbon. High on the thigh. Plenty instructions early on from both corners. Front kick again from Superbon, just testing the waters of the midsection. Gregorian wants to get inside those kicks and land the granite hands.
Here comes that pressure coming from Gregorian. Superbon's already starting to let go of those kicks, utilizing the push kick well just to manage distance.
Look how Superbomb managed to frame him off and create that space. Shoots out that jab again down the center corridor.
Superbomb's got some really good extension. The way he's able to just extend out, he's able to find just a little bit extra on the reach.
Outside leg kick from Superbomb. Step through knee. Nicely done. Front kick again to the midsection. Belly button through the back. Superbomb pouring with the lead hand, measuring for that outside leg kick, and already you see the reddening on the lead thigh of Marek Gregorian. Another jab from Superbomb.
Superbomb, he's got to deal with this pressure, and I like the way he's trying to deal with it with that push kick. Gregorian's trying to circle him into that power side, and he's doing a good job of cutting off the corner so far.
Gregorian is going to try and get Superbomb to drop that left hand, so Marek can power over with the right.
Good job by Superbomb to circle out.
Gloves high on both men. Gregorian a front kick off the lead leg. Superbomb, nice little quarter angle. Fakes the low kick, then goes the outside thigh kick. High check from Gregorian.
I like the fakes coming from Superbomb as he's landing the push kick. You're gonna see him lift up the knee just to fake it, and then he's throwing something else.
Under 1 minute remaining, first round set for five, this championship fight. Loaded up on the right hand there, Gregorian. Drifts off to center circle, eats another jab. The jab has worked well. The leg kick's been the prime weapon for Superbomb. Knees from both men to the upper ribs. Superbomb gets the head off the center line, avoids the left. Double front kicks from Superbomb off the lead leg. Make it in triplicate. Jab again, the jab's getting through. Needs a right hand for company. Leg kick also connecting. There's already the swelling, the bruising on the lead thigh of Marek Gregorian.
Nice step through knee there off of the push kick. Everything's getting set up right now off of that lead push kick.
High instructions from Olivia Costa, former Muay Thai fighter. Roundhouse kick of beauty to the waist there, and another teep from Superbomb. Beautiful end to the first round from Superbomb, the world's champion. All right, let's go to Rich Franklin, the Ace Hall of Famer. Rich, your thoughts after one.
Yeah, Superbomb's doing a great job of creating that distance there with that front push kick, and he's actually stepping backwards and utilizing that link that Mitch brought up before. Jab. If I was in Gregorian's corner right now, I would tell him, listen, you need to back Superbomb up against the cage so that he can't move backwards. When he had Superbomb backed up against that cage and was cutting off the corners, he did his best work there in combinations.
Great to have the expertise of Rich Franklin with this dragon. Unofficially on my scorecard, I'll go 10-9, Superbomb after one.
Yeah, he looks real sharp. He's able to utilize that push kick, keep the distance, and just understanding that range is what he's doing. I like the way he's faking it. He's landing the push kick, and then he's fading, and he's utilizing the jab well. And he's also starting to touch up the face of Marat. Marat needs to put a little bit more pressure on him and land some big shots.
Jab from Superbomb to a high lift round kick to open up the second stanza. Nice front kick. He's been using that front kick off the lead leg all night. Four punch combination from Gregorian. Couldn't land a clean blow, however. Superbomb circling into the power side of Gregorian, showing little respect for the right hand. Nice two-strike combination from Superbomb. Pokes him with the right hand. Misses with the outside leg kick there, Superbomb. Gregorian trying to measure for the right. Good step through knee to the upper left rib cage. And again, that teep off the lead leg, causing problems for Marek Gregorian. Jab again from the champ. Oh, look at that. Little pirouette. Gets underneath the left hand of Gregorian.
Beautiful angle creation by Superbomb. I'd like to see him spin off and then throw something. But I think he does respect the power of Marat. He just knows the range and the distance at which those punches are coming. Oh, so he's able to do things like that.
That was the tape kick off the back leg. The power leg from Superbomb switches it up. Gregorian's got to solve the problem of the jab and the front kicks. Superbomb, though, cannot get overconfident and start to drop his hands. He knows that Gregorian can knock him out. Took 28 seconds last time. But since then, both men have been undefeated. Gregorian, tight double forearms guard. Comes in jabbing, eats that right hand. There's the front kick again from Superbot. Jab two from Gregorian, falls short on the cross. Look at this, the opening, finding it between the arms to the midsection that's also reddened on Marat Gregorian.
Nice body shot landed by Gregorian. Superbond's doing good work at this distance, though.
Left hook from Superbond. Gregorian went downstairs. Gregorian got to start to apply more pressure on the inside here.
I think he heard you. He's starting to do it, Michael.
Front kick off the lead leg again from Superbond. These ones are high.
But he needs to deal with that. I'd like to see him parry that out of the way. Try to get out of the way of that push kick because it's scoring every single time. Nice body shot, though, landed by Gregorian.
Round kick from Superbond. Gets the head off the center line, evades the right hand, not so the leg kick. Good front kick, digs the balls of the feet, sways the toes. Perfect technique from Superbond. Gregorian, key eyes after these techniques.
Now Gregorian's starting to land, putting the combinations together. I like him following up with the leg kick. Nice little uppercut combination there.
Maybe the best punch so far from Gregorian. Good outside leg kick, high on the thigh. We go to the towels, into the second. You're watching 1X. Wherever you're joining us on pay-per-view right around the world, hope you're enjoying this opening match.
I like the way Superbond is interrupting the rhythm of Gregorian, right? He's throwing something, usually in mid-combination of Gregorian. Gregorian needs to find a way to complete his combination, maybe create a little bit of an angle after he throws two, step off, throw the third, and then the fourth, because he's there for the answer, and that's where the interruption is occurring.
Next round, please stay focused. Take more water and stay focused. Now you're doing great, but next round, please stay focused more.
It's what I spoke about in the previous round. He's got to stay focused, not get complacent, not get overconfident. And the corner's recognized that too. Superbond, I've got him ahead two rounds after two. 10-9 in both rounds for the champion on my unofficial scorecard. Gregorian has got to find a way to get past the front kicks. Past the jab. Superbond kicking to the ribs. In the first round, he went to the left. Now the right ribs of Gregorian are ready. Marat trying to close the distance. Go inside the phone booth to land the hand. Nice left hook, just kicked him. A little too shallow on the jaw. But nonetheless, the signs are there from Marat Gregorian.
You can see Marat's trying to push forward. A lot more aggression coming from the challenger as he's marching forward, landing some significant shots on Superbond. This pressure is starting to go.
Step through knee from Superbond. Knee from Gregorian off the right. Jab two, kangaroo from Marat, then through the left hook. Uppercut. Superbond attacking the ribs here. The right side of the body of Gregorian looks like it's sunburned. And they clinch. 150 remains.
Superbond let go of a few of those kicks. I like how he switches to southpaw to start going to those body kicks of him. Right there, that left kick is beautiful.
Oh, the elevation of the counter. Beautiful stuff from Superbond. That was super. Gregorian touches him with the left hand. Superbond closes him down, advances to his corner. Damaging the ribs again. He's perhaps trying to get Gregorian to drop that right arm and allow him to come over the top with the left roundhouse. There it is. Uppercut from Gregorian. Little grin there from Superbond. Another uppercut went higher than my cholesterol. Both men trade kicks. Push off. Nicely done from Superbond. Gregorian thought about the bolo punch. Step through knee from the champ. Nice, tape off the back leg.
That's what he's doing, is to keep that distance, because you can see the pressure just keeps coming from Gregorian. Gregorian's broken a lot of people's spirit with this relentless pressure, but Superbond's utilizing that push kick just to interrupt the pressure coming from Gregorian.
30 seconds left. Superbomb with the counter right. Gregorian covered up. These kicks of Superbomb, the placement of them. The teeps to the midsection. The left round kicks to the ribs. His left and leg kicks. That's how he left him at home. There's one. After he used them so well in the opening round. Step through knee. That is placement.
But as we hit those championship rounds, Michael, is this volume of Murat Gregorian going to start to wear on the champion?
Another round in the books, Dragon. How did you see it?
Slight edge to Superbon.
Okay, let's get the thoughts from the Hall of Famer, the ace, Rich Franklin.
Yeah, I really like the way that Superbon is managing the space between these two guys. You can see there when Gregorian landed that combination on the inside, it's when he had Superbon's back up against the cage. He landed that beautiful uppercut. But Superbon's doing just such a good job with that teep kick, the front kick, and the jab as well. So Gregorian has to shut his footwork down.
Unofficially, I've got it 30-27 for the champion Superbon after three. From inside the sold out, an amazing sight. Singapore Indoor Stadium for 1X, the featherweight kickboxing championship of the world on the line. And immediately back to the teep from Superbon. Some power in that left from Gregorian. Superbon momentarily dropped his right hand. Gregorian goes head hunting. Still dangerous with the hands, Murat Gregorian.
Always dangerous with the hands, Michael. It's Gregorian.
Tries to create room, forces the uppercut. Nice overhand right there from Murat. Carries the front kick. Disguised the needed Superbomb. Uppercut from Gregorian. Leans into the low kick. Doesn't parry the teep. Chance for a knee. It's a high kick instead from in close. Hard to throw, hard to land. Double team. Oh, step through knee. Tries to fold him in half like a piano accordion.
Hides that well. Everything's being set up off of that teep.
Long range teep.
Didn't quite find the target. Going back on the bike, trying to push forward.
I wonder if some frustration is creeping in on Murat Gregorian. Superbon takes the leg kick. Half uppercut from Gregorian. Teep again from Superbon. Step through knee. It's a beautiful technique. Gets under. Weaves the hooks. Counters with a kick off the lead. And another front kick off the back leg.
Superbon's not throwing the right kick as much as he normally does. He's kind of throwing it to the leg and also as a push kick. He's throwing the left kick a lot more. I wonder if something's going on with his right leg.
Loads up on the body shot to Superbon, forces him back. There's a step through knee. Every round, Superbon is bringing something new to the party. In this round, it's the step through knee to the body. The tenderized, battered, bruised, the kaleidoscope of colors on the body of Murat Gregorian. High kick from Superbon, going for the headache maker. Uppercut from Gregorian. Superbon tries to sweep out the inside leg. A teep off the back leg. Step through knee again. Oh, the jab. Superbon working these subtle angles, making it hard for Gregorian to find him when on the inside. You've just got to look at Gregorian's body and the story it tells. The reddening, the bruising, the punishment he has endured from the knees and round kicks and front kicks of the champion. Another round in the books, I feel, for Superbon.
Well-managed round for Superbon. Good use of the push kick. Just keeping him at bay. And he's dealing with this really well, this relentless pressure that comes from Superbond. Look at him. I like the way he's utilizing that uppercut. But then Superbond keeps going back to the kicks, keeps finding a way to keep Murat Gregorian in his kicking range and just doing a lot of good point scoring. Boom with the knee. I love that step through knee. One of his major weapons of this match has been that push kick, fake the push kick, step through with the knee.
Folks, as a thank you to our fans, you get to award one performance bonus of the night. Head to one social media platforms to vote now. Who should get a performance bonus? Make your vote. Final round. Unofficially, I've got a 40-36 to Superbond after four, which means Gregorian needs to knock the champion out. Superbond jabs. What will he bring to the table in this round? And Gregorian ups the tempo. Raises the aggressor meter. He must. Front kick. Knee. Gregorian grunting. Ki. Nice low kick from Gregorian. Timed that well. And Superbond smiles at Inciavis. Yep, not bad. So too the uppercut. Do you feel dragon? Do you sniff? Do you sense that Gregorian is going to find the target here?
I think he's going to try to. I think he's going to do everything in his power to find it. And you can see it. That left uppercut is really scoring well for Gregorian. Especially these close range shots right there. Boom, that uppercut again.
How Superbond manages to throw that high kick from such close range is phenomenal. Jab 2 falls short. Superbond lands the right cross, lands the front kick, as he has all night. Uppercut, just not enough mustard behind it. Step through knee from the champion. It has worked a treat for him. The ribs and the solar plexus of the challenger have taken an absolute shellacking. Again, round kick to the ribs, poking jack, step through knee. On the inside, Gregorian hoping for that diesel piston of an uppercut. Right hook to the mandible. Another one comes over the top. Superbond got to be careful not to leave the arms hanging out there when he tries to frame off. Teeps again. Used defensively. Used to set up something else. Hit off the center line. Worked nicely for him. Beautiful. Gets it off the center line again. Avoids the jab. Under a minute remaining for Marek Gregorian to find a knockout on Superbond. He loads up the right. Loads the uppercut. Almost took out the ring locks. Seconds to go now, Dragon.
Murat's trying. He's trying to push forward, trying to be aggressive. But Superbond's just distance management is so difficult to deal with. Even when Murat gets close, Superbond's able to utilize that beautiful footwork just to find the angle and then counter.
We told you Superbond was a whole different breed of animal. Since the Superbond that got knocked out in 28 seconds by Marek Gregorian some 4 years ago. Gregorian's got 15 seconds to find a knockout. Eats another teep and another teep. Thought about a needed Superbond. Final 10 seconds. Is that the last uppercut from Murat? The right hand from Superbond. Is there one big punch from Gregorian left? There is not. We are going to the judges as Superbond pumps the fists into the air. He is extraordinary. Many people call him Buakaw 2.0. A Thai flag in Superman style is worn cape fashion. Superbond. Look at that. That's amazing to try and throw a head kick from such close range. Very difficult. Step through knee was a treat in the third, fourth, and fifth rounds, particularly the fourth round. The teep all night. Gregorian tried the uppercut time and time again, just couldn't get off that one big salvo he wanted to land clean. Let's go to Tom Lau and find out our winner.
To present the belt for this match, we have the chairman and CEO of ONE Championship, Mr. Chatri Sitjodong. And now, ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And still, one featherweight kickboxing champion of the world, Super Bob.
No doubt about it, and the scary thing is, he's getting better. And that wasn't just a win, that was domination of Marek Grigorian. I had every round for Superbot. Grigorian's ejected, but Superbot is quite simply the best. He's now with the Dragon.
I am here with your champion, Superbot. What an amazing match. You got revenge for that knockout you suffered many years ago. How do you feel about your performance here tonight?
I feel I am so proud to myself because I can tell the world I am the real number one in the flyweight right now. Woo!
You're not just number one, you're the champion of the world, my friend. Your distance management, your range was superb. Was that the game plan facing such an aggressive striker like Marat Grigorian?
Yeah, I want him like many years after I lose to him, how he got. He just got the power, and I move from the power. Power cannot beat me right now.
Well, nobody can beat you right now because you look spectacular. Do you have a message for possibly your next opponent, the winner of the World Grand Prix, Chingiz Alazov?
We are friends, but in the cage, in the stadium, in the ring, I will beat him.
There you have it. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for the...
Happy birthday, Soran, my nephew.
Happy birthday. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for the one featherweight kickboxing champion of the world, Superbon!
The champion, the pound-for-pound number one, Superbon. A scary individual. He makes it look easy. And next up, the winner of the featherweight World Grand Prix, Chingiz Alazov, who beat Sinichai earlier on today, will get a crack at the gold. And you've got to wonder who can possibly stop Superbot. An amazing way to kick off 1X from inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Folks, we return on April 22nd for one Reloaded, and it's a stacked card. He's striking his next level.
Beautifully done. Look at that hook.
He's got power. He's got dynamite in his hand. Oh, there it is. The big kibosh. This could be the beginning of the end. Oh! It's over now. Reloaded is going to be crazy. Have a look at this. The lightweight kickboxing championship of the world. Rekin Ersel defends against Arian Sadikovic. Also on that card, our co-main event is going to be a rip snorter. The strawweight Muay Thai world championship. Smilla Sundahl of Sweden takes on the USA's Jackie Buntan. Folks, we are moments away from an extraordinary match backstage. The living legend that is Edward Flying, the former one lightweight champion of the world. He takes on a 10-time kickboxing and Muay Thai world champion in his last ever fight. The gunslinger from Australia, John Wayne Parr. One last time, the farewell of the gunslinger, WMC Muay Thai world champion, looking for career win number 100 tonight. That's what he wants. Number 100 to say goodbye to the fight world as a competitor forever. It is the match we've all been waiting for. John Wayne Parr, Edward Folaya. 10-time world champion. There may be no bigger name in Western Muay Thai then Wayne Parr.
I want them to remember my last fight as something that was memorable. I need this 100 win more than I need to breathe. And this is everything to me. I want to make the crowd lift off their seat and cheer. So after I do retire, that I don't just fade away, that people will still regard me as one of the top fighters.
Gusto kong itest yung sarili ko. Pinaka-importante naman yung legacy kang naiiwan para sa mga kabataan, para sa mga sumusunod sa bansa mo. Rather than na-reach ko na yung age na mag-retire ako, sayang, hindi ko kasi binigay lahat, di ba? Tinitingnan niya ako as hindrance para makuha niya yung 100 win niya. Tinitingnan ko din siya as a threat, hindrance doon sa goal ko na maging mas magaling pang martial artist.
When my fight came out with Edward, with his wushu style and my Muay Thai style, it's going to be a very interesting contest because the contrast is so different. He's a great champion. He has such a unique style. It's so exciting.
Marami akong natutunan sa wushu na pwede kong gamitin dito sa Muay Thai. O may mga techniques ng wushu na pwede kong ma-surprise sa kanya pag nagharap kami.
I believe with my Muay Thai skills and the Muay Thai rule set, it's definitely going to be in my advantage. I want to be aggressive. I want to put on good combinations. I want to have a finish, an exciting highlight reel knockout that people will talk about for many years to come.
As long as you have the passion and hahanapin mo yung way para ma-achieve mo yan. Napakalaki ng bagay na to. Nagpapasalamat ako sa One dahil binigyan ako ng pagkakataon na after 10 years andito pa rin ako, nasa main card. Ito yung passion ko, ang mundo ko na to. Hindi talaga ako magre-retire.
If I die tomorrow, hopefully I can be the guy to inspire the younger generation to compete in martial arts.
Emotions are running high. The last fight ever for the 10-time world champion Wayne Parr as he looks to win number 100. I've been commentating the man for 24 years. So it's with great sadness, yet always with great enthusiasm, that I give him one last send-off. In a style Australian fight fans know so well. Here he is then. The gun-slinging, leg-tracking, jaw-smacking, career-ending, mind-bending, spirit-crushing, flesh-mushing, bone-breaking, headache-making, blood-spluttering, liver-shattering, leg-rattling, tooth-cracking, John Wayne Parr. One more time. One last dance. Tonight, we say farewell to a legend.
I'm bummed. I've only been able to commentate this man twice. You speak with such enthusiasm and passion, and John Wayne Parr invokes a sense of nostalgia every time. I grew up watching this guy. I remember being in this stadium watching you commentate him in 2008 when he was on the Contender finale against Yotsing.
Right here in Singapore. And have a look at his career. 99 career wins, 46 knockouts, WNC Muay Thai World Champion, one of 10 world title belts on his mantle in Queensland, Australia. I know his wife, Angie, and three children are watching. Indeed, so many Aussies are tuning in and so many around the world. Arguably the most famous Western Muay Thai fighter since the late Ramon Tekka. A name known worldwide. Adored throughout his entire career. In one of his very early pro fights, he fought at Lumpini Stadium. Then he won the King's Cup before he returned to Australia in 1998 and made his debut there. What an applause for the living legend, John Wayne Parr. One last time for the Aussie. That familiar music, the red backdrop, the fabled Team Lakai Red Trunks on the former one lightweight champion of the world, Edward Velayak. In the Philippines, he is an absolute megastar. Folks, don't forget to check out the Apprentice One Championship Edition, now streaming on Netflix. It's been a sensation. Check it out. The Apprentice One Championship Edition, now streaming on Netflix. When he won the world title, Manny Pacquiao was there. He put the belt around the waist of Edward Velayak. Anyone you talk to in the Philippines, from Manila all the way to Baguio City, everywhere, they know the name Edward Velayak. It is a name revered. When he won the world title, they had a ticker tape parade for him in the streets. Mitch, you used to live in Manila for a long time. He really is demigod status in the Philippines.
I have walked through the streets of the Philippines with Edward, and he is mobbed. The Filipinos love this man. People around the world love this man for very good reason. The former one lightweight world champion has the most bouts in one history. He's been doing this as long as I have, except he's been fighting. I've been talking about it, Michael. He's also got three SEA Games gold medals in wushu, which could be the difference.
He uses his wushu in mixed martial arts. We've seen it before. It's all close quarter stuff with elbows, spinning elbows, hard hands, big leg kicks, cutting side kicks. The striking of Velayak is phenomenal. His leg kicks are incredible. But Wayne Pass says it doesn't matter how good your MMA leg kicks are, fella. They cannot beat my Muay Thai skills. It's Australia versus the Philippines. Wayne Parr at 45 years old stands 7 centimeters the taller and has a 12 centimeter reach advantage. Muay Thai rules, 3x3, three judges circle sided scoring on a 10 point must system. Here's Dom Lau.
And now, this next match is 3 rounds of 3 minutes in a 1 lightweight Muay Thai contest. This match is presented to you by Holcim. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, he is a WMC Muay Thai world champion, standing at 177 centimeters tall, weighing in at 169 pounds, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 99 wins and 35 losses. Training out of Buntu Gym, representing Australia, John Wayne, the Gunslinger Park. Introducing his opponent out of the red corner. He is a former one lightweight world champion, standing at 170 centimeters tall, weighing in at 169 pounds. Training out of Team Lakai, representing the Philippines, Edward Landslide Hooligan. And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Ilias Galapsis.
Red, blue, set a circle. 3 rounds, Muay Thai. No striking to the back of the head or to the groin. Be strong, be fair, obey my instructions all times. Touch gloves. Good luck, let's go.
Final instructions from Ilias Galapsis. Inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium for 1X. Can you believe it's come to this? The final fight of that man, John Wayne Park. A one Super Series debut for former lightweight world champion Edward Velayak. Legend versus legend, and even that is an understatement. Velayak returns to his striking roots. Wayne Park looks for career win number 100. Both men in orthodox started already. Edward loading up on the heavy leg kick. Wayne Parr returns the favour, doubles up off the back leg. There's one of those wushu side kicks I spoke about. Oh, Wayne gets caught with a left hand. Heavy artillery early here from Edward Velayak. Wayne's going to check those kicks. Edward comes over the top of the right. Another side kick from the Team Lakai combatant.
JWP is going to try to close that distance, and Edwards going to try to catch him coming in.
Side kick again from Falaya. The wushu technique of a three-time Southeast Asian Games gold medalist. Outside leg kick there from Wang.
Edwards timing that left hook quite well. He's got good distance management. He's on his back foot, though. That pressure from JWP is coming. He's got to be careful with that left hook, especially when he throws that leg kick. That right hand's coming down a little bit off his chin, which is leaving his chin wide open for that left hook.
Body shot there from Falayang. Backs up par a couple of paces. Good round so far from Edward Falayang. Jump turning back kick, hoping to find the liver of the Australian. Left hook from Edward Falayang. It's all power salvos from the Filipinos. Spinning heel kick. The acrobatics. But Wayne Parr remains composed. Body shot from Falayang. Digs to the liver like he's digging for oil. Goes to the bread basket. Another side kick. That one to the waist. R edges forward. Looks for the outside lead thigh. Spinning back first. It's a specialty of Edward Falayang. Ah, who said he studied the tapes of Martin Ewan's knockout of Edward Falayang, hoping he can also time an overhand right. Nice left hand. Wayne goes downstairs. Two punch combination. Misses with the outside leg kick as par. Oh, par nicely sticks him with the right hand and saw the heel kick coming. Carries the side, kick as Wayne. Outside leg kick from Yossi, then goes up to the ribs. Just trying to get the distance, the timing on those leg kicks. Good high check from the Aussie. Spinning heel kick again. Hooks it there and a cutting side kick to the sternum from Falaya. Turning left hand. We go to the towels at the end of one. Unofficially, I'll go 10-9 for Falayang after the first. From inside the sold-out Singapore Indoor Stadium, 1X is certainly alive and a happening. Let's go to the Hall of Famer, Rich Franklin. Rich, your thoughts after one.
Yeah, John Wayne Parr in this match, he's going to have to do a better job of closing that distance down on Falayang, because Falayang is an explosive athlete. He's quick, but you can see that Parr has started actually making some adjustments in the timing of those punches. So he looked much better towards the end of that round to me than he did at the beginning of the round.
Okay, takes a big breath, this 45-year-old Wayne Parr, and his farewell fight. But the first round belonging to Edward Falayang, who came in all guns blazing. The heavy artillery.
I'd like to see Johnny Parr put some punches behind, in front of those leg kicks that he's trying to throw. It's going to be really hard to hit Falayang with those leg kicks because Falayang's got such good movement.
Clash of leg kicks. Parr goes up to the ribs. Gets out of the way of the spinning hook kick. Jab to outside leg kick is what Parr was hoping for. Edward saw it coming. Ah, continues to hunt after the lead thigh of the Filipino.
And now we're starting to see Parr put those punches in front of that leg kick. He's having a difficult time cutting off the angle. You can see he's kind of following Edward around.
Can Wayne Parr get inside these kicks and land those tremendous hands of his? Does have a stellar pro boxing record as well. Had a big win in Australia over Anthony Mundine, of course. Round kick from Parr. Round kick, or back kick, I should say, from Edward Falaya. Parr edges forward, always coming forward. Body shot from Falaya. Good leg kick from the Filipino.
Michael, you spoke about John Wayne Parr watching the footage on the spinning back kick, but he just doesn't seem to have the speed to do it. He's just kind of taking it and blocking it rather than stepping forward like that to launch that right hand. But if Edward keeps throwing it, he might be able to time it eventually.
The spinning heel kicks of Falayang are ferocious. Outside leg kick from Wayne. No hands over the top for company. There's a right hand from Falayang. Wayne backed up against the fence here, takes the right hand, goes down! Alistair Lofton puts a count on one palm. He took a clean right hand.
7, 8, look forward.
Wipe off the gloves by the count of 8. Okay to go on here. The crowd trying to rally behind Wayne Parr. Flying going to the body with the right. Spinning heel kick. And a side kick. It's the Wushu. A low check there from Parr. Flying, confidence oozing out of every pore. He backs up Parr again. The head kick. Parr needs to dig deep into the well of guts and Aussie intestinal fortitude. Body shot. Body shot. Spinning a heel kick. Flyweight putting on a show. Sticks the jab on the schnoz. A side kick. Right hand from Parr over the top of the ear. Body shot from Wayne, still coming forward. Right to the round kick. Hope from the right hand, a turning left there from Flyweight. Another hook kick, and another side kick. Another round for Edward Flyweight. And the knockdown makes it 10-8. Wayne Parr up against it in his final ever fight.
Wayne Parr's got to be very careful closing the distance like this, because of moments like that. That was a beautifully timed right hand by the landslide as he starts to put it on JWP. That scores as a knockdown. That's going to go 10-8 in favor of the Filipino striking machine, Edward Folayan. And he's just doing a good job of picking his shots carefully. He's not gassing himself out. He's not doing anything extraordinary. All he's doing is picking his shots carefully.
You're the king, let's go. Last one.
There is 3 minutes remaining in the career of the legendary Wayne Parr. He's corner telling him, you're the king, you're the man. Let's go, Wayne. It's time to find that Aussie battler spirit. 3 minutes to go. Outside leg kick from Wayne to open up the third. Inside leg from Flyan, then goes to the body. Right hand there from Flyan. Rich Franklin, your thoughts?
You know, I'm looking at John Wayne Parr here, and if I was in his corner, what kind of solution I would give him? Fighter, but when you look at what's going on here, Flyan is definitely the more explosive fighter, but on top of that, every time he's landing a strike, even if it's a spinning back kick, it's taking John Wayne Parr's balance. So what he should get inside, and just being inside isn't good enough, because Flyweight is too quick. He needs to get a hold of him, grab him, and maybe try to utilize that clinch. Something different.
Wayne Parr tries to get on the inside. A short flurry from the Aussie. He's bucking up Flyweight. That's a head kick. He's got Flyweight on the back foot. Had he capitalized? Outside leg kick. Jab two there from Flyweight. Under 2 minutes remaining in the career of Wayne Parr. Right hand from Flyweight, but Wayne always coming forward. He does not know how to wave a white flag. Flyweight, Ki-Eye, behind the right hand, spinning back fist, and Wayne just brought the right glove up in time. Jab from Wayne, gets out of the way of the counter, checks the low kick. Round kick from Wayne to the upper right ribs. Throws a right hand lead. Jab gets out of the way of the spinning back fist. 1 minute 20 now. Will there be a miracle for Wayne Parr in Singapore tonight? There's a right hand from Wayne. Jab two. And he eats a right hand from Edward, who circles off. Another ferocious right hand from Edward. Thought about a side kick. Wayne tries to go the overhand right. Tries to thread it to the temple. Wayne covers the body, goes head up to it, just defends against the bullet, up in there! He tagged it! Wayne Parr tagged it! The fight on its feet! This is crazy! This is bananas! cartwheel kick. My word, a standing freaking ovation. Filipino as they went to war. JWP bringing every bit of his legendary experience out as he takes to the air with the flying knee and then starts to put it on Molayan. Beautifully timed uppercut, had him on the retreat.
What a moment.
It is history in the making. History made. You'll always remember, folks. You'll always remember where you were when you saw Wayne Parr in his last ever fight. I'll never forget it. My 35th time commentating Wayne Parr. And how about Edward Falaya? Let's go to Tom Lau.
This match was presented to you by Holcim. And now, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision, Edward Ulaya!
I am here with your winner, Edward Foleong. What a battle you had. Everybody on the edge of their seat. What is going through your mind sharing the circle with a legend like John Wayne Parr?
Well, John Wayne's retirement fight is a great privilege, you know. A lot of fighters want to meet him once, even in his retirement, but the privilege is mine. You know, I know he never retired in martial arts. Probably he will retire in fighting, but martial arts is his life. I know that.
Well, this is your return to the striking art where you started. How do you feel here in one super series? And we will see you again in striking only.
Wow, it was indeed a good fight, you know. Probably I can do a karate versus wushu against Sage if he likes. We will do it in one super series.
I like that matchup. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Edward the Landslide Foleong.
I'd like to thank everyone for coming here tonight to my kababayan. Thank you for supporting Filipino mixed martial arts. And above all, I just want to thank my Lord Jesus who gave me the strength to be here in battle. I would like to thank John Wayne and also my coach, my team. Thank you.
Mate, it's come to this. This was the last one. What's going on in here right now? What's going on in here right now?
Disappointed that I didn't get the win because that was my last one. I just want to thank the world for all your support. It's been an absolute honor to be a martial artist for the last 35 years. I'm heartbroken I didn't get the win, but
he is a legend.
I want to thank Mr. Chatry for giving me this opportunity to fight for one championship. It's an absolute honor to be here. Just thank you to all the fans for the last 30 years. You guys have been amazing. And just thank you from the bottom of my heart. And if you're ever on the Gold Coast in Australia, come to my gym and come and do a session. I'd love to meet everybody.
Wayne, I know that back home, the family are watching in Queensland, Angie and the kids. One last message to them, mate. What do you want to say?
Oh, I'm so sorry I didn't get the win. I love you guys.
Mate, I've been with you since 1998. I love you, brother.
Thank you, Singapore. Thank you, Australia. Thank you, the world, for all your support all these years. It's been an absolute honour, and I can't thank you enough.
Ladies and gentlemen, one last time, please be upstanding for a living legend. What respect, honour, integrity between these two warriors. But for the last time ever, we say farewell and thanks for the memories to the one, the only, John Wayne Parr.
What a send-off for an absolute legend. John Wayne Parr says goodbye to competitive martial arts. But ladies and gentlemen, don't forget, still to come. What a moment for John Wayne Parr, the Gunslinger's final ride. An incredible last moment.
And there it is, folks. The gloves laid down forever on the career of an all-time legend. Well, folks, she's become one of the most amazing stories in martial arts history. From zero to global hero, the great Stamp Fairtex journey continues tonight.
Stamp Fairtex is the Atomweight World Grand Prix Champion. Stamp Fairtex will take on Angela Lee.
In Thailand, Muay Thai is more than just a martial art. For many, the sport represents hope for a better future. Born into a family of humble fruit farmers, Stamp Fairtex started competing at a young age. Unlike most, she began her journey because of the need to protect herself.
ตอนนั้นอยู่อนุบาล 3 สมมุติเป็นคือเราตัวเล็กเราก็จะมีเพื่อนแบบแกล้งเราชอบยิกเราเราก็จะสู้ไม่ได้เราก็กลัวเพราะเขาตัวใหญ่กว่าก็เราก็เลยอยากจะซ้อมมวยต่อยมวย
At the tender age of 6 Stamp stepped into the ring for her first fight. Her early days of training for protection sparked a fire within her that grew into a passion for competing.
จังหวะตอนนั้นคือไปชกก็คือเป็นงานวันเด็กค่ะก็เลยได้เปรียบคู่ชกกันแล้วก็ได้คู่ชกมาแล้วก็ยกแรกเลยค่ะหนูตีเข่าเขาน็อกค่ะ
The young fighter was unstoppable, defeating both female and male opponents over the years. By her late teens, Stamp had almost cleared out the competition, and she thought about calling it quits.
ไม่คิดค่ะเพราะว่าต่อยมาได้พักหนึ่งมันไม่มีตัวต่อยค่ะและจังหวะนั้นก็คือมีเทรนเนอร์ที่แฟร์เทคที่ค่ายต้องการมวยหญิงเพื่อที่จะฝึก MMA
Our trainers recommended her and scout her She was pretty good you know some training would get her to a better level and then she started MMA
I'm a lifelong martial artist and I have a knack for finding talent which is why I've traveled more than 10,000 miles from my home in search of the next warrior.
The first tryout I ever held was in Thailand. I was sitting at the tryout watching two guys on the mat. Suddenly, I hear what sounds like a cannon off to my side. Boom. And it's boom. And it just keeps hitting. Captures my attention. That girl happened to be Stamp. The moment I saw Stamp, I was like, I gotta recruit this girl. I want her in my organization.
ว่าเราสามารถที่จะพัฒนาไปได้อีกค่ะเขาก็เลยเลือกแตมในวันนั้นแล้ววันนั้นก็ทำให้แตมดีใจมากๆค่ะที่แตมได้สามารถเปลี่ยนชีวิตได้ค่ะแล้วใน OWS ครั้งแรกค่ะที่สิงคโปร์คือตื่นเต้นมากๆค่ะ
Fair to say you've been impressed and that's probably why my goodness me my buddy Mitch Chilson didn't even get a word in edgeways.
That superb knockout in her first mixed martial arts bout propelled her onto the global stage. One championship came calling, and Stamp couldn't resist the lure of an immediate world title challenge in kickboxing.
And here are the knees of the midsection from Stamp Fairtex.
Stamp ก็รับโอกาสนั้นมาค่ะเพราะมันเป็นโอกาสที่ดีมากๆค่ะที่ได้ต่อยที่เมืองไทยด้วยแล้วก็เป็นการชิงแชมป์ด้วยค่ะแล้วStamp ก็อยากจะพิสูจน์ว่า
20-year-old Stamp Fairtex is now the Atomweight World Champion.
In just her next bout, Stamp made history when she returned to her Muay Thai roots.
And Todd takes the punishment!
And added the Atomweight Muay Thai World title in the progress.
Stamp Fairtex now the first two-sport world champion in one championship history.
วันนั้นแตมภูมิใจตัวเองมากๆค่ะที่แตมสามารถทำได้ค่ะ
สูงสุดขนาดนี้แล้วก็สามารถแบบชนะชูตาให้พ่อกับแม่ได้ขนาดนี้ภูมิใจค่ะภูมิใจมากด้วย
What a superstar! She has her sights set on becoming a three-sport world champion. That is unprecedented. For Stan, oh yes, oh yes, oh yes! The submission Thailand wanted to see.
หนูติดตามแองเจล่าลีมานานมากค่ะ
เป้าหมายระยะสั้นในตอนนี้ก็คืออยากจะต่อยอด MMA ไปเรื่อยๆค่ะแล้วก็ไต่ระดับคนเก่งๆไปเรื่อยๆจนถึงแองเจล่าลีให้ได้สักวันนึงค่ะ
The division's best atomweights will battle in the greatest women's tournament and the winner earns a title shot against Angela.
หลายคนมองว่าหนูไม่สามารถทำได้มองข้ามหนูไปว่าหนูไม่สามารถชนะได้หรือ
Emma! She got it! She got it! She got it! Stamp Fairtex subs out 3-2! Stamp Fairtex is the atomweight world Grand Prix champion!
ที่หนูดีใจที่หนูชนะได้แชมป์เวิลด์กลางปีเพราะว่ามันเป็นบทพิสูจน์สำหรับหนูค่ะที่หนูดีใจมากๆค่ะที่ได้สักวันหนึ่งได้ขึ้นต่อยกับเขาเป็นเกียรติกับหนูมากๆเลยในชีวิตค่ะก้าวเดียวค่ะที่แตมจะได้เข็มขัด MMA ค่ะแองเจล่าลีคือไอดอลของหนูค่ะแล้วเขาก็เป็นฮีโร่ของหนูด้วยค่ะหนูจะแสดงศักยภาพที่ดีที่สุดให้แองเจล่าลีเห็นค่ะถึงเวลาที่ต้องเปลี่ยนแชมป์ได้แล้วค่ะหนูจะมาเป็น unstoppable คนใหม่ค่ะ
And there she is, the globally adored, universally loved Stamp Fairtex, who tonight in our main event tries to become a three-sport world champion. But moments away, it is a grudge match 14 years in the making. Sexyama's here, and he takes on a man who truly hates him in Shinya Aoki. This one is going to be nasty.This one is going to be evil. This one is going to be awesome. It all began 14 years ago. It came to a head this week. First of all, Wednesday night at the press conference, Aoki, Sexyama, head to head. Remember, Aoki called out Sexyama, had some choice words that I cannot repeat on live television about Sexyama. And then last night, Chatri Sichitong had to stop them from going at it on stageAt the official weigh-in and face-off. Look at this. Look at Akiyama step into Aoki. Aoki's drawing to him back. And Chatri gets between them. They were ready to go, especially Akiyama. He is horrified by the things that Aoki has said. That one is going to happen next. From inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium, Aoki versus Sexyama, the grudge match we've all been waiting for.
They have at least a decade of hate and anger and bad blood between them.
Akiyama, Akiyama, omae, oi, tsugi wa, omae da, oishi, kumi wa atte matte kai.
だから、それにしても口悪いですよね、とは思いました。
嘘つくんじゃねえよ。おい、なんとか言えよ、
どこの田舎のクソヤンキーだみたいな思いましたけどね。
It's
an epic, epic match between two Japanese legends who are still red hot. Part of the animosity comes on Shinya's side because he doesn't really respect Akiyama as a martial artist. Shinya looks at Akiyama's current time and sees him riding the wave of being a celebrity rather than a true martial artist.
まあ、正直なところ何言ってるか分かんないんですよね。けど自分はただ単に自分のことをやってるだけの話なんですが。Shinya
Aoki's the most submissions in one history.
We are seeing version 2 of Shinya Aoki, who looks as dangerous as he was when he first won the One World Championship. And he wants to send a personal message to Akiyama that after all these years of Akiyama getting the spotlight, getting the magazine covers, getting the TV ratings, that now it's time for Aoki to take that spotlight and not just take it away from Akiyama, wrench it away from him.
だからこの格闘技って面白いんでしょ。いくらこう着飾ったって、いくらかっこつけたって、試合には自分以上のことは出ないって。みんな闇ろって言うんですよね、周りは。まあ原点、まあ単純なことです。本当に楽な道と難しい道があったら、難しい道を取れって親父にずっと言われてるんで。この
10年、 12、3年やってきたっていうことに対する、まあ答え合わせというか。
はい、勝つつもりではいきますけど、本当に喧嘩するんだったら本当にやるよみたいなで思っちゃうんですよね。別にどうやってフィニッシュするとか、どうやって勝つとか、まあ、どうやって勝ちたいのか別に何でも、とにかく勝てればいいです。Shinya
Aoki does not want to just beat Akiyama, he wants to hurt Akiyama. Aoki, he's nasty.
The two greatest of all time in Japanese MMA history, finally they get to meet. Somebody's getting finished. Either Aoki gets KO'd or Akiyama gets subbed.
The familiar strains of Andrea Bocelli and Sarah Brightman, time to say goodbye. And there he is, Sexy Armor. Sexyama, 46 years old. And when he takes off that judo gi, you are going to see the body of an Adonis. Akiyama, people have told him he shouldn't have taken this match against the red hot Shinya Aoki, who is out for blood and for breaking bones. The audience pops for the physique. Women in the crowd shrieking dragon. It's good special reason. Every time Akiyama enters the circle. I mean, since the days of Dynamite and Dream, it's special, isn't it?
Well, he's a legend in Japanese mixed martial arts with good reason. The third degree judo black belt has been racking up finishes throughout his entire career. But usually they come on the grappling side of things. He's coming off of a huge knockout win going backwards. And because Shinya likes to rush forward to get that takedown, you have to be very careful when approaching Akiyama because he can put you out with a hook. Akiyama is very highly skilled, Michael. This is going to be a really interesting matchup because of his judo skills and ability to defend that takedown.
Mitch, will it be a case also of who can curb and control their emotions better? Because because there's so much emotion in this match, especially from Aoki, who genuinely hates Akiyama.
I don't know, man. When Shinya's angry, he reaches a different level.
All right, remember Hirota? Many years ago, what he did to Hirota? The way he broke his arm and flipped him off? I think that's the nasty Aoki we're going to see tonight. An ovation here in Singapore for Sexy Yama. And you know this song. Baka Survivor. My 27th time commentating Shinya Aoki, and it never gets old. The man of 1,000 submissions. I remember once dragging, he did a reverse go-go plata in Dream. We dubbed the Aoki plata. This guy can pull submissions out of anywhere. He can make them up on the spot. You've rolled with him. What's it like rolling with Shinya Aoki?
You know that feeling in the pit of your stomach when you're about to take a test and you didn't quite study for it and you know you're gonna fail? That's what it's like to grapple with Shinya Aoki. And it is just demoralizing once this guy grabs a hold of you. He is so strong and he is so skilled, he might not look it, but this dude is one of the most powerful grapplers I have ever had the pleasure of rolling with. And I roll with a lot of high-level world-class grapplers. He is so slick when it comes to submissions. He is so innovative, so creative, but also, he's got a mean streak, Michael.
Let's see if the mean streak comes out tonight. Look at the credentials. 30 submissions, 25 in the first round. The most submissions in ONE history. Two-time ONE Submission of the Year winner. The former ONE Lightweight World Champion who says he wants the belt back. Does he look amped? Does he look ready? Does he look about to take home a souvenir limb of Sexy Yama? The question is, again, will emotions get the better of Aoki? Can you see him keeping it in check and maybe not exposing himself to a silly mistake?
Emotions usually hinder inexperienced fighters, but when you have this kind of experience, this kind of pedigree inside the circle...
Yeah, but Dragon, Aoki has disliked opponents before, but this time it's genuine hatred. It's different. It's a different level. It really is. It's an all-Japan battle. Aoki, the younger by 8 years, the taller by 2 centimeters, 4 centimeters in reach. It's Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu versus Judo. It's so much more than that, though. 15 minutes will be judged in its entirety. To introduce them, let's go to Dom Lau.
And now, this next match is 3 rounds of 5 minutes in a ONE Lightweight Mixed Martial Arts Contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, he stands at 178 centimeters tall, weighing in at 168 pounds, training out of Team Cloud, representing Japan and South Korea, Yoshihiro Sexyama! And introducing his opponent out of the right corner, he is a former ONE Lightweight World Champion and the number 3 lightweight contender, standing at 180 centimeters tall, weighing in at 165 pounds, holding a mixed martial arts record of 47 wins and 9 losses. Training out of Evolve MMA, representing Japan, Shinya Tomikatsudan Aoki! And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Mohamed Sulaiman.
Center, please. Center. Okay, you both understand the rules, okay? Let's keep it clean, keep it active. Obey my instructions at all times. Touch glove if you want, then back to your corners.
The final instructions from Mohamed Sulaiman. Akiyama is raring to go. So too Aoki. Circle door closes. Inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. The bad blood has been simmering for 14 years. Now it comes to a head. A dream match. Expect dynamite right on the line between two pillars of Japanese mixed martial arts. Aoki looking for an early takedown.
Aoki immediately closed that distance and attacks the single leg. What's Akiyama's defense going to be like as Shinya jumps to the back?
Aoki, the aggressor meter on high early on.
Akiyama's got to get him off the back. He does not want to tangle with Shinya Aoki with back control. He's got to try to press his back up against the wall and defend this back take.
Shinya Aoki, the human backpack in the opening 40 seconds. Figure four wrapped around the body of Sexyama. Two of the all-time great Japanese mixed martial artists, two legends who do not like each other, especially the man on the back of the other. Aoki hates Akiyama.
Shinya doesn't need to be under the net to finish this. He can face crank Akiyama and just he has such a tremendous squeeze.
Hunting for the finish early, Shinya Aoki. Rick Franklin, what a start here from Shinya.
I'll tell you what, this is classic Shinya. Mitch talked about this before, and this is a position you don't want to be in because he's like having a boa constrictor on you. Just little by little, you can see this position going from bad to worse. We can't see if the arm is underneath the chin right now, but this is not where Akiyama wants to be.
Referee Muhammad Suleiman looking closely, shaking his head, said not yet, but is it going to happen? Is Shinya going to submit it? He's squeezing.
Oh, you can hear him gurgling, Michael.
Akiyama defending! Akiyama in trouble! Oh, gee whiz, look at this! Excruciating!
Oh, he defended it well.
Aoki resets! The crowd popped for Akiyama! It sounds like they're behind Akiyama here in Singapore! 2:45 remaining, first round of three. Sexyama defending. As Mick said, you could hear him gurgling.
One move.
The glove just becoming a little loose. Aoki famous for not wearing any wraps. And he pounds away to the side of Sexyama's head.
Watch the back of the head. Watch the back of the head, Shinya. Shinya, watch the back of the head.
Wants to sink the submission, wants to strangle him. Okay. Softens him up some more.
Gotta watch the back of the head. You gotta watch, Shinya. Okay.
Shinya's like, is that okay? How about I hit him here? How about I hit him there? The crowd booing Aoki. He's the villain here in Singapore. Now it cranks. It's a crank now. Cranking and wrenching and squeezing the face of Sexyama. The boos go up for Aoki again. Akiyama defending Dragon.
This is the exact same position that Aoki finished James Nakashima in. But Akiyama is doing a good job at defending this position right now.
Rich Franklin, your thoughts as Akiyama gets softened up again.
Yeah, Akiyama's doing a great job of defending this position. But keep in mind, he's carrying all Shinya's weight. And that's going to weigh on him as the rounds progress through this fight. The one thing you got to keep track of, though, is Shinya has this triangle lock around Akiyama's body. But you can see it starting to slip to the top of the foot. And that can be putting a lot of pressure on Shinya's ankle. He's not careful in the later rounds.
Aoki twists. He twists. Look at Akiyama's face and Akiyama defends. He's safe again. But for how long? Mitch, this is intense. This is intense.
Yeah, Akiyama must have an incredible pain tolerance because those face cranks have made a lot of people tap before. But not Yoshihiro Akiyama. Look at Shinya's gripping him tight, trying to find the right angle on that rear naked choke. But you can see how Akiyama's keeping his chin nice and tucked. So it's hard for Aoki to get underneath the chin.
15 seconds to go. In a round, Murakiyama has carried Aoki like a backpack. He's defended the chokes, defended the cracks. And it looks like we're going to go into the second round. But how much of a toll has it taken on Sexyama as we say that's a tremendous amount of time to carry another man on your back?
Yeah, but Akiyama's got massive legs, man. Are you okay? He's strong.
Are you okay? You just have to do two more. Two more of this. It wasn't bad. I think it's good. I can see you very well. The first move is important. Focus in the beginning. You have to be careful in the beginning. And then if you grapple, you have no problem. Just do the same thing. Just do it properly again.
Shinya's advice was to get exactly into the same position that he wants to be in, but he's got to be very careful on the entry. You can see how Shinya kind of comes forward with his hands extended. He's looking to grapple. He's looking for that clinch.
Second round, and Akiyama comes forward on Aoki now. Aoki in southpaw stance. And Akiyama affects a judo takedown. Shinya shoots in for a single. Akiyama defends through a spinning back fist. Akiyama showing no signs of fatigue. A high knee there from Aoki. Clinching knee is what he was looking for again. Shoots in for a single Aoki. Akiyama rains the puncher to the jaw! And the crowd loving it!
Shinya's eating those shots. Good job by Akiyama to dig the underhooks to defend. You can see Aoki tried to go with the wizard, tried to go with the hip toss, but the third degree judo black belt was able to stop that takedown attempt. Now he's pressing Aoki up against the wall and Aoki spins off.
Akiyama throws a right hand. Aoki goes back. A nice hooking right hand there from Shinya.
If things don't go Aoki's way, he starts to get discouraged. And we've seen this in the past. If Akiyama can keep this pressure on and land some good shots, he can discourage Aoki.
Roundhouse kick from Aoki. That's the power left.
Nice right hand. Right.
Oh, another one. Oh, smack back! Aoki, the call! What a flurry from Sexyama.
Oh, he circles the back. Oh, look at that.
Oh, here we go. Here we go. This is crazy. On the knee. Akiyama. Aoki's hurt. Aoki's hurt. Isn't it? And good night, freaking Irene. Sexyama. 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 He bludgeoned him. I'm looking around the arena, everyone's on their feet, everybody. Talking about this for a long time, and look at the respect. The martial arts Bushido code. After all the trash talk and 14 years of rivalry, they are true martial artists who can respect one another. Look at this. The knee and the bludgeoning. He did not stop. Aoki gritting his teeth, taking punishment. Didn't respond. And Sexyama, Yoshihiro Akiyama, unleashes hell on Shinya Aoki to settle their grudge. If you did not like that, there is something wrong with you. that had everything. Non-stop action. Look at this. Look at Aoki's face. Oh my goodness. Let's go to Dom Lau. Incredible.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Mohamed Sulaiman, has called a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 50 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of technical knockout, Yoshihiro Akiyama!
That is massive. Sekiyama with the dragon now.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am here with your winner, Sekiyama. Yoshihiro, there was a lot of bad blood coming into this matchup. And then when he got your back and had that face crank on, how tight was it?
たくさんの、いや、それがありましたけれども、あの先ほどの組技で、あのどれほど苦しかったですか？途中で負けそうになりましたけど、けどセクシーヤマとみんながやってくれたんで力が入りました。
At some point, I thought I was going to lose, but everybody called me Sexy Yama, and I gained my power.
We could almost feel the momentum shift to your favor. Take us through this incredible change of events as you were able to turn it on in the second round. When did you know things were going your way?
2 ラウンド目で勢いがシフトしたと思うんですけれども、 どういったところでその力というか波が変わったと思いますか？
2 ラウンド始めた時に青木選手の顔を見た時にですね、一瞬引いたんですよね、目が。そこが狙い目だと思ってここで行かないと負けちゃうと思って行きました。
So when the second round started, I saw in his eyes, Aoki, there was like there's a glimpse of like doubting himself, so then he thought that this is the moment, so I went all in.
All in is right! Sexy Yama, you're 46 years old. What is next for the legend that is Sexy Yama?
Sexy Yama として次のステップは何でしょうか?
もっとセクシーな試合をします。
I bring more sexy to the fight.
You know what's really sexy, though? Is the $50,000 bonus that Chatri Sinyotong just gave you. Ladies and gentlemen, show your love to Yoshihiro Sexy Yama Akiyama.
I tell you what, folks, inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium right now, it's indescribable. The atmosphere, the emotion, the crowd sold out. Ah, it's incredible. And that man, Sexy Yama, the love, the outpouring. Folks, plenty more coming your way, including our special Super Rules matchup. Demetrious Johnson backstage, the all-time mixed martial arts great, 12-time flyweight MMA world champion. He's getting ready, and he's always ready, but he's going to have to go through 3 minutes of living hell, and then he gets a chance to do this, mixed martial arts style against Rodtang. If it goes to the second round, the wrestling, the transitions, the submissions, TJ's got it all, but he's got to get past the first 3 minutes. He takes on a monster with over 300 fights, the most vicious, the most powerful Muay Thai fighter on the planet. The one flyweight Muay Thai world champion, Rodtang. Look at what he does. He is scary. He just breaks opponents apart, and no matter how hard they hit him, he doesn't flinch. Look at this, clean shots from Daniel Williams. Look at the way he drops Jonathan Haggerty in the body shots. The man is an absolute monster. It goes down soon in our super fight. Bye. live from Singapore on a Saturday night. It is 1X, the biggest show in martial arts history. We move on to the Flyweight Championship of the World. And have a look at this. Last night of the weigh-ins. Yuya Wakamatsu, Adriana Moraes head-to-head, and Yuya steps into the champ. Yuya has vowed he will knock out Adriana Moraes. Moraes has vowed he will submit Yuya Wakamatsu. We park our peepers backstage, and there he is. Yuya Wakamatsu, who hits like a truck. If he hits Moraes clean, the champion is going to sleep. But Adriana Moraes, Mequinho, is a man who can submit you from so many positions and knock you out. The magnificent new world title belt has been on a journey. Thanks to Toomey, the journey continues tonight.
The belt represents the journey, the entire lifetime journey of the very best of the best martial arts in the world. It's a journey filled with thousands of hours of training, of heartbreak, of passion, of excellence, of grit. Our belt is a symbol of true meaning of martial arts, values of integrity, humility, honor, respect, courage, discipline, compassion.
Sometimes you battle through adversity in life, but you try to keep on pushing through it.
It's a whole army to build a champion.
With you, I have courage, I have strength, I have what you need to win the world title!
The belt, genuinely, is not only a stunning piece of art, but it's a labor of love and design. And ultimately, it's reserved for only the very, very best. The best in the world.
It is all about that gold, the brand new World Championship belt, 26.4 pounds, the heaviest, the biggest world title belt on the planet. Gold, pure leather, jewel encrusted, and in that custom Toomey case. It's all about the Flyweight Championship up next. Adriana Moraes, the champion. Yuya Wakamatsu, the challenger.
DJ's heard! It's goodnight, Irene! Adriana Moraes defeats Demetrious Johnson.
It was an amazing moment to defeat the great of all time. That helped me to give me confidence.
And still!
Yeah, I was shaking. I was like, Yuya, you did it, man.
My goal right now is keep my legacy, keep my belt. I'm there to defend what is mine.
Oh, he caught him!
Yuya Wakamatsu has been unstoppable in the flyweight division.
One day, champion belt to win, it's a good thing. I'm going to show you the best of my life. I'm going to
He evolved a lot, his MMA game, but he never fought against one guy like me.
So,
I'm gonna bring violence. I like to see blood. I like to make my opponents hurt. That I love.
Oh, there's the over!
Everybody knows who is the best in this division. I'm no joke. I come with everything that I have.
The little piranha, Yuya Wakamatsu. After losing to Demetrious Johnson, he changed everything. His training, his mindset. Now he's on a 5-fight win streak. 6 wins in a row will equal the record for the division. But more importantly, 6 wins in a row means he is the world flyweight champion. The power in this man's hands is phenomenal. He says Marias can overlook him all he wants on the ground at his own risk. Doesn't matter though. Yuya says he knocks out Marias on the feet.
Also, like you say, in here, no one should be sleeping in here. It's just a bit of a negative. It's got to sleep in here, walls to live. You come up a close and you need strong a bit.
It's all about power in the hands. It's also about not overextending. Like Amatu says, the days of going nuts in the opening round are over. He plans to pace himself. Use every round to his advantage. Break Marias down over 25 minutes if necessary of non-stop pressure and find a way to finish the champion.
Yuya Wakamatsu, legit one-touch power. He hits you with that right hand, and he will send you into the shadow realm. He is a smooth striker. He's got great footwork, but the way that he lunges into that right hand is a thing of beauty. He's coming off of a unanimous decision win over a very talented striker where he showed us improved grappling. And he is going to have to utilize that grappling here tonight, especially if Adriano Marias tries to take him down. Yuya is riding a 5-fight win streak. He's got 11 knockouts, and most of those come with that right hand. 7 of those have been in the very first round. He touches you, and you are time traveling. He earned this shot with 5 wins, very tough wins, and looking better, showcasing new skills all along the way. He realizes that this is his shot at the brass ring, and he is going to do everything in his power to grab it.
Little piranha, Yuya Wakamatsu, and he become Japan's second world champion made at 1X. He flew under the radar for so long, didn't he? And then what happened? One on TNT series, he knocked out Demetrious Johnson. And suddenly, everyone around the world knew what we'd known for a long time. Just how damn good Adriano Marias is. 7-time one flyweight world champion across 3 title reigns. Considered now the best pound-for-pound mixed martial artist in one after beating Demetrious Johnson, now wants to establish his legacy. Sold out inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium for 1X. The thumping music for the champion Marias. All eyes are on him after the DJ knockout. He needs to prove it wasn't just luck. Marias says, I know Yuya's got knockout power. But once I get my hands on him, Yuya will have no answer for my BJJ.
That BJJ, Michael, is a thing of beauty. This dude hunts more necks than Dracula. He is trying to strangle his opponents. He is so good on the ground. This Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt is a high-level submission artist. But now, Adriano Marias has knockout power. That knockout of DJ is going to go down in history as one of the biggest shots. And now he gets a shot at the new case holding the gold.
Yes, indeed. Who will take on the belt? The journey continues with Toomey. There's the gold in the background inside the Toomey design case. A final inspection of the amazing flyweight champion of the world, Adriano Marias. What a decorated athlete he is. 7-time one flyweight world champ. Only one world champion with 3 title reigns. The most wins submissions and finishes at one flyweight. An MMA knockout of the year over Demetrious Johnson.
Adriano Reyes walking into the circle. Here we go, baby.
Reyes shakes it off and is ready to defend the flyweight gold. It is the old rivals, Brazil versus Japan. Reyes, the elder by 6 years, the taller by 4 centimeters, also the reach by 4 centimeters. Our global mixed martial arts rule set for this one, 25-minute bout, judged as a hold. Knees to the head, as Reyes knows, are perfectly legal. Here's Dom Lau.
And now, this next match is 5 rounds of 5 minutes for the one flyweight championship of the world. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, he is the number 2 flyweight contender, standing at 168 centimeters tall, weighing in at 135 pounds, holding a mixed martial arts record of 15 wins and 4 losses. Training out of Tribe Tokyo MMA, representing Japan, Yuya Little Piranha Uagimatsu. And introducing his opponent out of the red corner. He stands at 172 centimeters tall, weighing in at 134 pounds, holding a mixed martial arts record of 19 wins and 3 losses. Training out of American Top Team and Constrictor Team, representing Brazil. Please welcome the reigning and defending undisputed one flyweight champion of the world, Adriano Miquinho Moraya. And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Mohamed Sulaiman.
Athlete, center, please. Yeah, you both understand the rules, yeah. Let's keep this clean, keep it active. Obey my instructions at all times. Touch glove, back to your corners, please.
The flyweight championship of the world on the line. Our instructions from Mohamed Sulaiman. Circle door closes.
Dutch.
Marias ready.
Dutch.
Wakamatsu ready.
Athletes ready to go? Let's go!
It is 10.02 p.m. on Saturday, March 26, 2022. Wakamatsu City knocks out Marias for the title tonight. Marias the champion, no longer flying under the radar. Wakamatsu, center circle. Marias, huge, tall for a flyweight. Wakamatsu's going to set that right hand. One chance is all he needs, one opening.
This is what we saw from Adriano in the DJ matchup, is this utilization of the space. He really understands footwork and how to look for these openings. Yuya is just waiting patiently, trying to unleash that right hand.
You know Adriano would have trained for that for months. He knows that's the prime weapon of the little piranha. With outside leg kick from Wakamatsu. Legs here from Wakamatsu. Marias, a nice head kick there from the champion. Another head kick from Marias. He's got some snap to it, so it's fast. Maybe doesn't pivot, maybe doesn't talk, but he's got a snap.
There's the first stance change from Marias. Look for him to go southpaw and then start throwing those kicks. Nice jab landed by Yuya.
Outside thigh kick from the champion, then goes the inside thigh.
Yuya looks relaxed, composed, calm, just choosing his shots carefully. I like these touches though by
Yuya
Marias.
Or Marias?
Both of them actually.
Marias is landing the more shots at the moment. Yuya hasn't really thrown anything.
But Yuya looks patient though. He doesn't look... He's not too fidgety, he's not overextending, he's very calm and real patient. Adrian has landed some kicks, landed some shots, moving around, trying to find his angles.
You can feel the intensity. Tremendous respect for both men's skill sets.
Stop! Athlete, stop!
And Muhammad Sulaiman wants more action.
More action. Ready to go!
He's basically saying, fellas, the filling up process, it ends now.
Man, these guys got 25 minutes, though. You gotta give them a chance to just sort of adjust to this moment right now.
Okay. Let's hear from Rich Franklin. Rich, your thoughts on the halfway point of the opening round.
Yeah, I'm with Mitch on that. You got 25 minutes, so this is one of those matches where you gotta pace yourself. And keep in mind, both of these guys have knockout power, so one little mistake and you get caught, and that's lights out for you.
Both men exchange your knees in the clinch, dead center of the circle. Jab two from Wakamatsu, miss it. Alright, leg kick, counter there from Wakamatsu.
Wakamatsu's trying to counter the leg kick with some hands, but Adriano is so fast.
Outside leg kick, Adriano. Some rigidity already above the lead knee of Yuya Wakamatsu. All right, let's fight. Long reaching left hand there from Wakamatsu. No home for the right hand yet, however.
Stop!
And another caution here. Last warning, or he's going to tip into the pocket and go yellow cards, and that will mean a 10% purse deduction.
Marias has yet to really fully commit to getting into range, and Yuya is just taking the center and waiting for him to come in. It's Marias that's dancing along the outside, really looking for his spots carefully.
Marias has the takedown.
He gets it beautifully timed, but Yuya pops right back up. He does not want to tangle with Adriano on the ground. He told me his sole mission is if he hits the ground is to get back up. But Adriano is a high-level black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, and he easily steps over into half guard.
Yuya did say, underestimate my ground skills at your own peril. Half guard position. Wakamatsu trying to get back to his feet. Gets there now, takes the back standing of the champion.
Crowd appreciation. Power from Yuya Wakamatsu as he's able to bridge out of that. As Marias gives up his back now. Good wrestling so far from Yuya. Let's see if Adriano chooses to separate those hands and spin.
That's what? 10 seconds.
Yep, just that. Goes chest to chest. Yuya presses him up against the wall. Might ride out the time here.
Okay, we go to the towels, end of round one. Don't forget, this is judged as an overall contest and not as five individual rounds. Folks, also, you can vote. We're giving you the opportunity. You get to award one performance bonus of the night. Head to one social media platforms to vote now. Who do you think? Who deserves a performance bonus? Okay, let's go to Rich Franklin. Rich, your thoughts after 5 minutes.
Yeah, you know, you saw the referee there warn them twice about stalling, and I think that takedown was a result of that right there, because Adriano was doing such a good job of managing that distance that Yuya felt the pressure from the referee, doesn't want the first deduction, overcommitted slightly, and Adriano was able to land that takedown.
Ready to rock and roll, second round set for five. Flyweight World Championship on the line. That's 1X from inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Referee Muhammad Sulaiman,
let's go,
getting a little fed up in the opening round with the lack of commitment from both men. Gave two cautions, no yellow cards yet, however. Will they turn it up? Inside leg kick, hard the femoral profunda there from Wakamatsu. That right hand is cocked and ready. Will he pull the trigger?
Action, red!
I think Yuya is going to have to be a little bit more cautious if this thing hits the ground again. He doesn't really want to explode like that, because now Marias is going to expect that type of explosion, and he's going to have a counter for it. Yuya needs to be a little bit more technical on his get-ups.
Marias can be a surprising and cagey customer. Did begin his martial arts career in capoeira. Nice knee on the inside from the chat. Jumping move! Good airborne. Decent hang time too there, Dragon.
Yeah, Adriano is explosive. And Yu goes, that's nothing. You didn't even touch me. Let's get back to dancing.
Fight fair from Wakamatsu.
That's what Yu needs to do. He needs to have a little bit more feints, just kind of draw out some movement. I'd like to see him score with some hand combinations and maybe leg kick. He landed a leg kick in the first five, and there's a right hand touch right there.
Counter right from the leg kick of Marais.
Because what the leg kicks are going to do, it's going to slow down this constant movement that's coming from Marais. Yuya needs a stationary target. He does his best work when he catches you coming in and you're not moving as much.
Yeah, but the crowd are booing now, too, and it may not be long before Mohamed Sulaiman issues another caution or maybe even a yellow card. The crowd getting restless in this flyweight championship match. Another hand right there from Wakamatsu. Singapore Indoor Stadium wants more action. Now they engage. Wakamatsu pushes him back against the fence. Nice corking knee and another one from Yuya.
This is the new level of Yuya's game that we saw him at. He went over to Sanford MMA, started working with Ung La and Martin Nguyen, and he really developed his cage wrestling and his ability to stop takedowns and also go for takedowns. So this is a new level for Yuya.
Rich Franklin, if you're in the corner of the champion, Adriano, what are you telling him to do?
I would tell him to just back off that cage, move around a bit, and keep managing that distance the way that he was. I also, though, when he's managing that distance, would like to see him being just a bit more offensive. There's little scores on the scorecard here, but nothing that's really adding up that's giving anybody a decisive lead. And you got to keep in mind, we're almost 10 minutes into this match at this point.
The crowd got excited momentarily. But Rich, I'll ask you this one. Have the crowd been right to boo and jeer? Has there been a lack of action?
It depends on what you actually value as a spectator of this sport. I realize that there's 25 minutes in this match. I personally like watching these guys just jockeying back and forth with their foot position and angling off to see who's winning that little battle. But these are my like tiny details that the trained eye can see that allows somebody like Adriano to set up for a kick like that. And if you're not trained to see that, then you won't respect those little things and you expect these bigger moves to come out.
Adriano's starting to confuse Yuya with this movement. You can see him switching back and forth. He was able to just get that head kick up there, and Yuya got frozen a little bit. He's kind of stuck here taking pictures. Yuya needs to be more offensive now. He can't. Yeah, I'd like to see him utilize those leg kicks. It's slow down this movement of Adriano.
Adriano faked a jumping knee, then went downstairs with a leg kick. Overhand right from Yuya, then throws a wild left hook. Shoots in the chat. Drives him back against the fence. There's a knee on the inside. Right hand from Adriano. This is more like it.
I like the way Adriano's mixing things up. He's doing a great job of threatening the takedown. He might not score it, but at least he gets Yuya thinking about the takedown threat. And then he's taken to the air with those flying knees. I think he sees something there.
Is the jaw of Wakamatsu. They'll tag it with a flying knee. It's a roundhouse kick.
Adriano's starting up the tempo with these kicks. He's mixing things up well. Because you can see the wide stance that Yuya has, kind of a karate-based style. And now Adriano is starting to land leg kicks both inside and outside. And he's scoring.
Makes the jab. Does Wakamatsu. Caught about a high rope roundhouse. Into the round. Crowd not appreciative of the action in this flyweight world title match.
Well, these guys, the crowd's been spoiled all night, Michael. We've had constant action as a beautiful takedown right there from Adriano, but Yuya did a great job of getting back up. Again, Adriano threatens with a takedown, beautiful positioning, good defense coming from Yuya Wakamatsu. Nice little right hand kind of threatened there, and again, Adriano takes to the air, pushes off, gets him back into position, and starts to look again.
Put your weight on her leading leg. Excellent.
We're
going to the third round. Let's start over again.
Okay, the corner of Marais want a fresh start from the third round. as the circle door closes, Yuya Wakamatsu, his chance for gold. Does not want to rue any missed opportunities.
Yuya's got to deal with this movement of Adriano. He's having a hard time. You can see him throwing these shots, and he's just airballing. He can't quite reach Adriano because of this elusive movement and stance switches. Adriano's very good at understanding range and distance. And this space, he's a veteran. He's been in here a long time. He knows how to utilize the dimensions of the circle.
Nice check there from Yuya. Adriano, lots of movement, and the referee doesn't like it. I think he's going to go in his pocket now. Yellow card coming. 10% of his deduction. If it happens, let's see. Okay, double yellow card. Rich Franklin, your thoughts on this?
At this point in time, this is probably warranted, particularly with what Mitch said, because we've had a really exciting round of fights so far. The thing I don't like about this match with these two athletes is neither one has a significant lead, and this is going to end up coming down if they continue running with this pace, with one of these guys just making a mistake and winning off of a slight margin at the end.
Oh, that was nice from Adriano, the duck under, to take the back. He gets one hook in, Yuya smartly goes to the wall and utilizes the cages almost like a defense.
Now the yellow card seemed to work. Adriano Moraes has upped the intensity here.
I gotta say, Michael, I am very impressed with Yuya Wakamatsu's takedown defense. Adriano has not been able to keep him on the floor.
Calf kick, corking knee from Wakamatsu. What is Yuya looking to do here, Dragon?
He's got underhook, and he's also going into between the hips there. He's looking for something. He's trying. He might try to reap out a leg and pull him into a takedown, but I think he might just be looking for possible separation here.
Yep. Come on.
Some tape coming loose on the glove there of Adriano. 3 minutes, 5 remaining. Third round set for 5. Flyweight World Championship. Still to come tonight, folks. Rodtang, Demetrious Johnson, the super fight is up next. Lots of instructions in Yuya's corner as he throws a high left round, then goes downstairs to the inside thigh.
And Yuya needs to be a little bit more active. He's getting a little bit gun shy. He's doing a good job defending, not taking a lot of damage.
Jumping
round. He's not being very active.
Yuya,
there he goes. Yuya with the takedown now. Let's see if he tries to suck the hips away and keep him down, or if he just tries to get back up with knee to the ground opponent, perfectly legal.
Right in front of our commentary position. A chance for Yuya Wakamatsu. Gets back to his feet as the champion. Yuya!
Nice double leg there. Was able to get the hands clasped, picked him up, put him down. Adriano pops right back up to his feet, though.
Knees from Yuya. The outside left thigh. Adriano grabs a leg.
Nice little hip switch right there to change angle for the single leg, and that just created separation.
Crowd appreciating it. Very educated crowd in Singapore. Jab from Yuya.
That was nice. He's got to do more of that. He's got to be more active with the hands.
Gets out of the way of the round kick. 1:30 remains in this third round. Takes here. Overhand right. Yuya takes the champ down again, Dragon.
Another takedown for Yuya Wakamatsu. Who would have suspected that one right there? Let's see if he chooses to pass guard or if he's just going to sit there in the guard and drop a little bit of ground and pound. Again, Dracula's jumping on the neck, though. He's got a good squeeze from this position.
Oh, it's over!
And he got it!
It's over!
Wow!
Adriano Moraes retains the Flyweight Championship!
Don't give Adriano your neck. He will choke you out!
said he would do. Submit Yuya Wakabata. Just when it seemed that Yuya had the momentum with three takedowns. Just when it seemed the pendulum had swung the way of the Japanese fighter. Adriana Moraes goes over to world multi-time BJJ champion Leo Vieira. Also the great Hento Gracie. Among our many luminaries here, Circle Star. A BJJ win from an amazing athlete. Have a look at this, jumping roundhouse there. Yuya the takedown. Watch the knee to the head, coming up. Beautifully done. Yuya, double leg, puts him down. Wonderful work here from Yuya. It seemed like it was all going Yuya's way. Have a look at this, where he gets into trouble. The neck is taken, the choke is sunk in. Referee Muhammad Sulaiman on top of it. And it's over. There's the tap from Yuya Wakamatsu. Let's go to Tom Lau to make it all official.
To present the belt for this match, we have the chairman and CEO of ONE Championship, Mr. Chatri Sityodong. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Mohammed Sulaiman, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 58 seconds in the third round for your winner by way of guillotine choke and still undisputed ONE Flyweight Champion of the World, Adriano Moraes.
All he needed was one opening, one chance to see your neck, take your neck, and tap that. The rain of gold continues for Adriano Moraes. Who can possibly stop him? And now the champ is with the dragon.
I am here with your champion, Adriano Moraes. What a tough match. Were you surprised at his willingness to engage with you in the ground?
Yes, of course, Yuya has hands. I need to be careful in the beginning of the fight because he's a KO artist. And I put my foot to work. And when I had opportunity, I submitted him.
Woo! Was that the game plan, to utilize distance management, pick your shot, and wait for the opportunity?
First of all, I want to thank you, these two guys over here. They travel with me. Without them, it would be much more hard for me, you know. And thank you very much, I love you. And I want to give a shout out to Macho Rogan. He supported the fighter, very good work you're doing, support us fighters. And G4U, the best law company of Florida, thank you. And bro, this is what it is. I'm the champion, I'm happy, and I'm thankful.
Well, you are the longest reigning champion in the flyweight division. You did it yet again. What's next for Adriano Moraes?
I don't know what's the next. Chatri, in the end of the day, he's so excited. He started to do something like it was impossible to come true, you know? Man, right now I just want to come back home, rest a little bit, you know, like come back to my fight camp, and let's see what's going to happen for me. I'm still champion, right? I need to defend the belt again.
You are still champion. We'll go home and celebrate.
Yeah. Aí, galera do Brasil, quero mandar beijo para todo mundo aí que torce por mim. Separa tempinho para estar me assistindo. Minha mãe maravilhosa, você não me tirou do orfanato à toa, não. Eu vim para brilhar aqui. É tudo nosso nessa porra aqui, ó. Beijo aí pro Renzo, pro Léo que tá aí, Catel Cubes, André. Todo mundo aí da 16, Brasília, é nós. Tamo junto. Brasília, Distrito Federal, tem campeão aqui que luta muito por vocês. Muito obrigado por tudo. Singapore, I love you, thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, show your love.
American Top Team, the best Jim, the world, thank you very much, guys. I love you all. Us!
Singapore, show your love to your champion, Adriano Moraes!
Lots of love being shown for Adriano Moraes, still the flyweight champion of the world. Look at that bout. Tremendous, isn't it? Okay, time to go backstage right now. There's royalty in the house. After a two-year absence, the Queen is back. Final preparations with her dad, her trainer, Ken Lee. Unstoppable Angela Lee. What a career it's been. From teenage world champion to mother.
There's no one like her in the sport. There's no one like Unstoppable Angela Lee.
The emotional outpouring for Angela as her father can embrace her.
The Lees are a true martial arts family. Ken and his wife Jules are decorated martial artists, and they introduce their kids to martial arts as soon as they could.
Martial arts, it runs through my family. My parents were both, you know, instructors, and as soon as I could start walking, that was pretty much when I started training.
We raised all our children with the martial arts, learning the self-defense, the discipline, and the competition was something that they chose to do.
It was actually my choice because growing up, I was a very competitive kid and I loved to win. That's the driving force behind why I started competing.
Oh, she tapped out. Wow, what a finish.
Angela Lee, amazing performance.
Since I was a kid, since I started practicing martial arts, I wanted to compete at the highest level, and that was to win a world championship in mixed martial arts.
This is for the inaugural ONE Championship Atomweight World Title.
Angela Lee jumps guard. Oh, she transitions into the back. That was beautiful.
Angela.
My initial reaction was, wow, I'm a world champion. And then later on, it's like people are writing articles and interviews are coming out saying, you're actually like the youngest person to ever do it. Just 19 years old. And then I was like, wow. That is really cool.
This feels really nice, actually.
I want to leave a legacy behind, and I'm going to be the champion for a very long time.
I'm fearless.
Angela went from an unknown teenager on her debut to a global superstar. The world champion became a target as challengers lined up, looking to dethrone the new queen.
She is quite simply the queen of the atomweight division.
Once you're at the top, everyone wants your belt and everyone wants to come after you. And so you always have to stay ready.
In 2019, the undisputed strawweight world champion, Xiongjing Nan, came after Angela in her atomweight belt. The epic clash headlined ONE Championship's 100th blockbuster show in Tokyo, Japan.
I am fully confident to defend my belt and show the world why I'm the champion of this division.
So many people doubted her, but not tonight. Tonight belongs to Angela Lee. At atomweight, she is still unstoppable.
At the peak of her career, Angela faced a new challenge, something that no amount of training in the gym could prepare her for, motherhood.
Hi, Ava, my baby girl.
Being a mother gives you an entirely different kind of strength. It allows me to have a whole new reason for fighting. She is my motivation and she is what I'm gonna be fighting for now.
The best atomweights will battle in the greatest women's tournament.
I was eager to see the true number one contender.
By the time it wraps up, I'll be ready to fight the champion. Everything kind of works out perfectly.
I was like really starting from zero. So many times I was frustrated because I wanted to get back to where I was faster and quicker.
Stamp's incredible! Oh! My goodness! She got her! She got her! She got her! Stamp Fairtex will take on Angela Lee!
2 years away is a long time. I definitely gotta bring my A game.
Stamp is gonna be, you know, pretty confident coming into this fight. When she faces me, it is gonna be different. Now that I'm a mom, and now that I have a baby, my why is greater. I'm in even better shape than I was, you know, before.
It's definitely gonna be, you know, my best performance yet, no doubt. For me, this is the next chapter, and I'm so ready. I'm so ready to be back.
Can't wait to see the Queen back in action very soon in our main event against Stamp Fairtex. But right now we head backstage at the Singapore Indoor Stadium. The all-time MMA great, Demetrious Johnson, says he'll have to survive 3 minutes of living hell against this man, Rodtang, holding a photo of mum and dad. It's all about family in the most important and biggest fight of his life. It's ready to go down. The super fight we've all been waiting for. Rodtang and Demetrious Johnson. Here comes Rodtang and an absolute destroyer. He is a smashing, thrashing, human wrecking ball. You are looking at the greatest 12-time world champion.
The DJ never gives you a moment to breathe. He's just constantly on you.
March 26th, 1X goes down. Crazy fight between DJ and Rodtang.
First round Muay Thai, 3 minutes. Second round mixed martial arts. Third round Muay Thai, fourth round MMA.
If it goes past the first round, it's gonna be over.
Rodtang is a slow starter. If he comes out too slow, it'll be over in the second round.
Either DJ is gonna get knocked out badly in the first round, or Rodtang gets subbed badly in the second round.
For me, it's always about opportunities and taking a risk.
He's gonna get hit so hard. How he responds to that, that's gonna be the key.
He's the best Muay Thai fighter in the world. His stand-up is on a whole new level. I'm gonna go out there and be very dynamic. When you fight somebody who's very straightforward, the best way is be dynamic.
Look at this monster! Look at this battle tank!
สมมติว่าวันนั้น DJ พลาดผมเอาชนะน็อก DJ ได้
The first round, I gotta survive. Second round, I get to go to my world to be what I do best.
If he manages to survive, I think Rodtang is gonna be in shock.
That was beautiful.
DJ is my boy. DJ can do Muay Thai with him. Second round, you can push it out and finish.
ที่ผมชื่นชอบในความไวของเขาในสไตล์ของเขาก็คือเขามีจุดเด่นตรงที่ความว่องไวเข้าออกไวแล้วเขาแบบก็อาจจะอ่วมก็ได้ยกต่อมาผมก็อาจจะป้องกันตัวแต่ผมก็จะมีลูกบวก
If Rodtang comes forward, he's gonna take me down. My job is to make him feel like he's drowning when I get him to the ground.
Wakamatsu could be in trouble.
คิดว่าไฟจะจบไงผมก็อยากเอาชนะน็อกคอยได้ครับ
I don't care how tough you are. If your brain can't get oxygen, you're going to go to sleep.
ฝันชกอยากจะชก MMA แล้วก็ได้ชกคนเก่งเนี่ยมันก็ถึงประสบความสำเร็จสูงสุดแล้ว
This fight is just added to my legacy. I'll be crazy not to do it.
Can he get it? That's good night, Irene! This is something sensational! The greatest mixed martial artist of all time. He is, in a word, phenomenal. There is nothing in MMA that Demetrious Johnson cannot do. But tonight, the multi-time world champion will suffer 3 minutes in a sport he has never competed in against a man looking to hurt him. Don't forget, grab our merchandise right now, our 1X hoodies, Shop now at one Top Shop World Champions. They're made here. For 3 minutes, DJ must survive the opening round under Muay Thai rules against Rodtang. Before this fight moves into DJ's preferred MMA rule set. DJ, one Flyweight World Grand Prix champion, 12-time Flyweight Mixed Martial Arts World Champion, 12 career submissions. Has he bitten off more than he can chew? First 3 minutes, Muay Thai. If he has, it's time for Demetrious Johnson to chew like crazy. He told us 2 days ago, fellas, the first round is going to be a living hell.
You know, I'm surprised he says that because Rodtang is not typically a fast starter, you know? So I think that DJ is gonna have to manage the space and the distance really well, keep moving, stay light on his feet. But DJ is a very high-level striker, so don't sleep on DJ in the first.
Personification of aggression. And not a bad dancer either. Only 24 years old with 319 fights to his name. He's never lost in one across 10 fights in 4 years. Rodtang, a name both respected and feared in the Muay Thai world. Rodtang says a tsunami of Muay Thai pain. Those are his words. A tsunami of Muay Thai pain is coming for Demetrious Johnson in the opening round. He plans to hit Johnson in a way Johnson has never been hit before. When he hits Rodtang, be it with punches, knees, kicks, elbows, he hurts. He hurts like hell. He wants to hurt Demetrious Johnson and drag him to hell in the opening 3 minutes under Muay Thai rules.
You know, it's going to be interesting to see what happens if DJ can get past those first 3 minutes, because Rodtang is a high-level striker. But also, earlier this week, I got a chance to play a little bit with Rodtang, feel what he's like in grappling. And I'll tell you this, Michael, this man is solid. I went in for a single leg, and he knew when to defend. He knew how to feel. Then I dropped to guard, and he was running around. He passed my guard, and I had to defend. He's very good, and he learns extremely quick.
How about the different approaches to the circle here tonight? Rodtang smiling, dancing, playing to the crowd, throwing T-shirts into the crowd. Demetrious Johnson, though, more business.
Yeah, but that's what happens when you've had 300 matches. You're relaxed. You're calm in there. And Rodtang, the Iron Man, has done it all 4 times. He has defended the one Flyweight Muay Thai World Champion, 10-0-1, undefeated. So there's a lot of swagger and a lot of confidence. And he knows that every single round is going to start on the feet.
The traditional project armbands around both biceps of Rodtang, a throwback to the roots of Muay Thai in Thailand, when men went into battle. Their daughters, their mothers, their wives would tear off a piece of their sarong and wrap it around the man's arm to give them good luck on the battlefield. It's carried over from the beautiful traditions of Muay Thai and ancient martial arts. Rich Franklin, I'm excited for this one. I know you are too, Ace.
Tang's going to have to be very strategic in this first round because there's a lot of things that DJ can do to just drain time off the clock. This is only a 3-minute Muay Thai round, so if he allows DJ to use the clinch, man, that could be a killer for Rodtang in the first round.
Okay, folks, we are ready for the super fight. The USA versus Thailand is finally going down. I can't believe we're here. I can't believe it's happening. Special rules super fight. Rodtang is the younger. He's only 24. Has the 8-centimeter height advantage, gives up 1 centimeter in reach. Now, rules for this one. First and third round, global Muay Thai rules. Second and fourth round, global mixed martial arts rules. DJ, can he survive the first 3 minutes of what he says may be a living hell. Here's Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the co-main event of the evening. Four rounds of 3 minutes in a one special rules super fight. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, he is the one flyweight world Grand Prix champion and a 12-time MMA world champion, standing at 160 centimeters tall, weighing in at 134 pounds, holding a mixed martial arts record of 30 wins and 4 losses. Training out of AMC Pancration and Evolve MMA, representing the United States of America, Demetrious Mighty Mouse Johnson. And introducing his opponent out of the red corner, he is the undisputed one flyweight Muay Thai champion of the world, standing at 168 centimeters tall and weighing in at 134 pounds. Holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 267 wins and 42 losses. Training out of Chitwanon Gym, representing Thailand, Rodtang, the Iron Man, And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Olivier, the boss, Toss.
All right, guys, watch out for the headbutt. Low blow, back of the head and spine. You both know the rules. Fight clean, touch glory if you want. By your corner.
Final instructions from the boss, Olivier Cost, inside the sold-out Singapore Indoor Stadium for 1X, a super fight, special rules match. First round, 3 minutes of Muay Thai. It's Rodtang's backyard.
Time.
And Rodtang wearing the mixed martial arts trunks tonight.
So
here we go. Rodtang immediately comes forward. And DJ's on his bike. Early. He clinches up with Rodtang. Throws the knees. Rodtang outside low kick. Front kick from DJ. Body shot from Rodtang. Big left hook from Rodtang. DJ moving, throws a high left. Inside thigh kick from Rodtang. Overhand right from DJ, a cracker, a beauty. Elbows from Rodtang in the clinch, a knee from DJ. Rodtang with a hook. The crowd loving it, the action. Round kick off the left leg from DJ. On the outside, Rodtang, body shot, inside thigh kick to the back leg. High check there from DJ. He's circling into the power side of Rodtang. Now goes the opposite way. Overhand right from DJ. Rodtang staying close. Body shot again from the tie. Fake there from Rodtang. DJ forced to cover up. There's an elbow. There's a knee from Rodtang. 1:49 remaining in the Muay Thai round.
You can see DJ's having a little bit of difficulty with the Muay Thai rule set. He keeps clinching and trying to look for a tie-up, but Rodtang is doing a great job of pressuring him into that.
Rodtang almost threw him into Olivia Cost. Inside thigh kick from Rodtang. Front kick to a round kick from DJ. Nice combination. Under 90 seconds remaining in the Muay Thai round. Can Rodtang get him out of there? DJ lands a good hook. Overhand elbow from Rodtang.
Rodtang definitely senses the urgency in these first 3 minutes. He's coming out banging.
DJ, he's equipped himself very well so far, I've got to say. He looks for a dump, can't execute it. Gut punching knee from Rodtang. DJ fires a knee to the upper left rear.
Up, break.
And referee, the boss, Olivia Cuff, breaks them. Under a minute remaining in the Muay Thai round. Body shot, Rodtang. DJ wears it. Knees from Rodtang, doesn't connect. Rodtang not trying to dump him, wants to work the elbows. And DJ who fires at a right elbow.
Good redirect from DJ to press Rodtang up against the wall. He's doing a good job of utilizing the clinch to throw those knees.
Is DJ gonna make it out of the Muay Thai round? It looks like 128 seconds to go.
Oh, he can't count Rodtang out. One shot can end the night for DJ. DJ has got to stay moving.
Again,
connection with the right hand.
Gin. Red. He's fast. Two. Rodtang coming forward. Final 10 seconds of the Muay Thai round. Big right hand from Rodtang. Inside thigh kick.
Done.
And there it is. DJ survived what he said would be a living hell. And we move into mixed martial arts for 3 minutes next round.
Look at Rodtang closing the distance, throwing big power shots. You can see DJ again, that's what he does. When he closes that distance, when he gets close to people, he tries to tie them up and drag them into deep water. But Rodtang did a beautiful job of manipulating these Muay Thai rules just to make sure he was in the space where he could do the most damage. But DJ was able to touch him with that right hand on multiple occasions. Very interesting first 3 minutes. I can't wait to see the next one.
Let's go to the ace, Rich Franklin. Rich, your thoughts after the opening 3 minute Muay Thai round.
Yeah, you can see DJ struggling with some of that clinch work there. Immediately when he threw that overhand right, he kind of came in with the leg for the shot. But he started making those adjustments towards the back end of the round, was able to chew some of that time off the clock. It's going to be interesting. It's going to be interesting to see how Rodtang deals with clinch and takedowns in this round.
Two. Second round. Now we're under mixed martial arts rules. Now it's DJ's backyard.
Completely different Rodtang. Now he's on the back foot, going backwards. Because you know DJ wants to get that clinch again, get that tie up, and drag him down to the ground.
It's only 3 minutes though. It's not the usual 5 minutes that DJ is used to.
Rodtang's got good movement on the back foot. Circling the cage really well, not allowing DJ to pin him up against the wall.
Can Rodtang get it into the third round where it shifts back to Muay Thai rules? DJ, taking his time. Does not want to make a silly mistake.
He knows he has to maximize time because he doesn't just have to fight Rodtang in this round. He's got to fight the clock in this round. He's got to utilize the time very carefully. And if he shoots one shot, he has to make it count.
2 minutes, 10 remaining in the second round. And the first takedown attack from DJ. Oh, we got him to the ground. He's got the back of Rodtang.
They're dry, Michael. They're not that sweaty yet. This is a bad spot for Rodtang. Rodtang should use the wall as a defensive mechanism to try to keep DJ from fully taking his back.
Rodtang carrying the weight of DJ, posting up on that right arm. The Thai defending. As DJ's gonna try and soften him up, try and look for the choke, look to strangle it. A bad spot for Rodtang with 1:35 remaining. Rodtang defending. Rodtang's never been in this position, never, ever in his life. With a 12-time world champion on his back, trying to choke him out.
Good defense there, how he had using his arm to prevent the hand from sliding out there. You can see DJ's trying to pull out the hand. There
this
he goes.
It.
Now it's under the mat.
This is it!
Rodtang's got to relax. He could panic tap.
Rodtang! Can he hold on?
Defense. DJ's gonna transition. He goes back to it. Rodtang's gotta continue to fight that top hand.
Rodtang! Is it gonna tap?
No.
It's a sweep! It's a sweep! It's out cold! It's good night, Irene! Demetrious Johnson puts Rodtang to sleep! Demetrious Johnson puts Rodtang to sleep!
What'd I say? Say it.
Congratulations, Mitch Chilson. You called it. Second round submission. Demetrious Johnson put Rodtang to sleep.
Wow, DJ gets the back, maximizes the opportunity, and chokes out the Iron Man. Mighty Mouse is victorious.
Have a look at this. As Mitch said, he was waiting for the right time. One attempt at a takedown. Got the back of Rodtang. The beginning of the end starts here and ends here. Rodtang survived as long as he could. And you know what? He didn't tap out. He did not tap out. He went to sleep. Let's go to Tom Lau, make more official.
You kicked me out. How dare you kick me that hard, yeah?
Has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 13 seconds in the second round. Or your winner, by way of rear naked choke, Demetrious Johnson!
Two tremendous martial artists with so much respect for each other. That was so entertaining. Look at this. To do this.
Thank you, you too.
It's incredible.
Who that, Mitch?
What up, DJ?
I am here with your winner, Demetrious Johnson. Let's talk about those first 3 minutes. You said it was gonna be a living hell. Did it live up to the expectations?
You know, the training camera was really hard for me, right? Sorry. Training was really hard for me, you know, but I had a great team around me. And they prepared me for this madness that we were going to succumb to. And, you know, they have my coaches, James, Tony, Charlie C3, Combat Club, and they got me prepared for this fight. You know, I knew it was going to be hell, and you don't get any, nobody remembers your name if you don't take risks. I knew he was the hardest hitting man in this whole entire division. Him and Nango are probably the pound for pound best strikers in the world. You know, but, you know, 35 years old, baby. I ain't no spurry chicken, but you know, I still fight.
If you take up here a look at the big screen, you can see in the first round, you had some problems with that close range. Yep. You got inside that clinch and you wanted to tie him up. What was going through your head?
So the game plan for this fight was to move around, draw out that left hook, boom, hit him with that, right? But he's got a chin for days, right? So I told my coach, I said, hey dog, we do come all to Singapore to get a yellow card. I'm not gonna stall. I'm gonna fucking fight. And I was like, he bullies people. I was like, he ain't gonna bully me, I'm gonna fight him. If I go out and get knocked out on my shield, I'll say, you know what, at least I tried. You know, you can't put somebody down if they're trying, right? So I was going to fucking fight, dog, that's all I did.
I want you to talk to me about round two, because then he entered your world and we saw a completely different striker. He was off of his back foot, but you were still patient and calm because you knew you only had 3 minutes to work.
Yeah, one of my biggest weaknesses in my skill set is that I want to rush the fight, right? I always overwork myself. I'm always pushing into the fight. My last fight against Adriano, I was pushing. He was doing this, he was doing that, and, you know, I ran his upper hook, whatever, the blip. But if I just take my time, let him run around, and when I got him, I had to channel my inner Bibiano, the man from the jungle. Bibiano's a nasty man. So when I got in his back, I was like, I'm just gonna choke him. I'm gonna squeeze. And if he goes out, he goes out. If he doesn't, we'll go to the third round and get back after it.
He's got an incredible chin, because you caught him a few times with that right hand. Were you surprised by anything else in there?
No, I was there live when he got hit clean with John Haggerty. I was there live when he got hit by Amanda T. I was there live when he got hit by Walter Conclave. He's got a chin. I know that. And it's not the first time I fought guys with chins.
Well, you ran through the World Grand Prix. You've had an incredible special rules match that really lit the world on fire. What's next for Mighty Mouse?
What's next for me? We go home to my beautiful family, jump on my dirt bike. I won't hurt myself, I promise, and get back to training. I think this training camp, fighter Rodtang, somebody who's so dangerous, really elevated my game, and I think I learned a lot from this, and I can't wait. Oh, actually, you guys see me in the summertime. I can't tell you when, but you'll see me in the summertime.
All right, well, we look forward to DJ in the summer. Singapore! Make some noise for Demetrious Mighty Mouse Johnson!
Not the time.
The old time great post
fight. Let me see that soon. Oh, hey, man.
Oh, wow. Give that respect.
I'll try this. I was going to tell you that. Woo! Yeah. Thanks, man. Thank you, buddy.
Number one.
Thank you.
Don't say that anywhere else. Absolutely incredible. Coming up next, Stamp Fairtex, Angela Lee, in our main event.
Welcome to the most exciting global martial arts event, ONE Championship. Here we go!
Blocked him with the right hand. Nice back. Oh, the big kibosh. What a night it's been here at 1X History in the Making, the biggest martial arts show of all time. From inside the indoor stadium here in Singapore, we're coming up next. It's our main event for the Atomweight Championship of the World. The Queen, Unstoppable Angela Lee, is back after 2 years. She takes on the rampaging Stamp Fairtex.
The reigning one women's Atomweight World Champion!
This will be my fifth title defense. Now that I'm a mom and now that I have a baby, my why is going to be greater, and I think that I'm going to be able to dig deeper and find a way to win.
The one Atomweight World Grand Prix Champion!
นักมวยตัวเล็กจากภูธรที่ไม่คิดว่าจะได้เดินสายนี้ไม่เคยคิดว่าจะได้มีโอกาสขึ้นมาขนาดนี้ค่ะ
She's been training since she was a little girl, as have I.
และหลายคนอาจจะดูถูกหนูไว้มากๆเลยค่ะ
I'm so lucky and so grateful that I have an amazing support system.
หนูก็เลยอยากจะพิสูจน์ตัวเองให้ทุกคนเห็นค่ะว่า
We are a close, loving family. We have been incredibly successful.
ไฟนี้ที่หนูชนะอยากจะให้ทุกคนเห็นว่าหนูเป็นแค่ผู้หญิงตัวเล็กๆที่สามารถพิสูจน์ได้ทุกๆอย่าง Yes, I can do it and I come from Thailand.
I've been the reigning champion since 2016.
Angela Lee เป็นแชมป์มานานมากแล้วค่ะแล้วตอนนี้ในรุ่นก็เริ่มน่าเบื่อแล้วค่ะสมควรที่จะเปลี่ยนมือได้แล้วค่ะ
She's coming for my title. She's coming for my belt.
ก้าวเดียวค่ะที่ตั้มจะได้เข็มขัด MMA ค่ะ
There's no way in hell that I would just give that up easily.
และตั้มก็จะเป็นแค่หนึ่งคนในประวัติศาสตร์ที่ครองแชมป์ใน3กีฬาค่ะ
She's trying to make history, but so am I. This will be my first ever world title fight as a mom.
ถึงเวลาที่ต้องเปลี่ยนแชมป์ได้แล้วค่ะหนูจะมาเป็น Unstoppable คนใหม่ค่ะ
There are levels in this game. I'm years and years ahead of her.
Stamp Fairtex, the X Factor. The entire world has embraced her, and her rise to stardom, from being a two-sport world champion Muay Thai and kickboxing, to being the fastest rising star, arguably in MMA history. And now here she is, and wasting no time for her world title tilt.
takedowns. She can truly do it all. And this is her moment to realize her dream of becoming a three-sport world champion.
She was born into a farming family in rural Thailand. They had nothing. She was bullied as a young girl. To overcome the bullies, she started training in Muay Thai. She later won a regional title in her teens, was discovered on Rich Franklin's One Warrior series, and here she is vying for the Atomweight Mixed Martial Arts World title. What a Cinderella story. In which she became a mother, and her daughter Ava Marie is here in Singapore with Angela. Lee returns to headline the biggest show of all time. She took the crown when she was only 19. She has held it ever since, and done so in devastating fashion. Many have challenged for the crown. All have fallen before the queen. For Angela Lee, at Atomweight, she is undefeated. She is unstoppable. She has meted out punishment for the likes of Mei Yamaguchi and Zhong Jinan. And tonight, she plans to punish Stamp Fairtex. But never before has Angela fought such a credentialed striker. Never before has she fought a two-sport world champion. But the queen says she is unfazed. The polar opposite to Stamp. Stamp grew up with nothing. Angela grew up in a martial arts family full of champions. Her father, Ken Lee, a martial arts champion. Her mother, Jewel Lee, a martial arts champion. She's married to a BJJ champion in Bruno Pucci, who you see there now holding her belt. She's had every opportunity, every privilege afforded to her, and she capitalized to become a great world champion, the youngest other women's world champion. An emotional moment with her husband, with her father, her brother Christian Lee, of course, former lightweight one world champion. Her sister Victoria Lee also fights in one championship. They're a family of amazing martial artists. Who will take home the belt? You see the belt in the specially designed Tumi case in the background. The journey continues with Tumi. The journey continues with Angela Lee, now a mother, in tremendous shape. She brings in that mother's strength. Trust me, folks, it's a real thing. Her reason for competing, her reason for wanting, no, I say for needing to win, has increased. Because she's got a daughter now, Ava Marie. Ava Marie is her why. It's why she's here. It's why she's defending the crown. It's why she's going to beat Stan Fairtex, says the queen.
Over 6 years as champion, 2,000 days as the one Atomweight queen, undefeated. The only time she's ever stumbled is when she chased glory up at strawweight. Now, she is ready to put on a show in the performance of her lifetime.
A rousing ovation for Angela Lee, who flies both the USA and the Singaporean flag. Oh, she looks ready, and she looks mean. Here's how they stack up in the Atomweight Mixed Martial Arts World Championship Showdown. Angela, 1 year the older, she won the world title as a teenager. Has the height by 7 centimeters, the reach by 10. 5 by 5-minute rounds, the belt judges a hole. Knees to the head of a grounded opponent are legal. For our introductions, let's go to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. 5 rounds of 5 minutes for the one Atomweight World Championship. This match is presented to you by Toomey, perfecting the journey. Our three judges scoring this bout at circle side are Thomas Genberg of Sweden, Adam Kayum of Australia, and Rosenberg Rossetti of the Philippines. Singapore! First, out of the blue corner, she is the one Atomweight World Grand Prix champion and a former two-sport one world champion, standing at 157 centimeters tall, weighing in at 114 pounds, holding a mixed martial arts record of 8 wins and only 1 loss. Training out of Fairtex Gym, representing Thailand, she is Stamp Fairtex! And introducing her opponent out of the red corner. She stands at 164 centimeters tall, weighing in at 114 pounds, holding a mixed martial arts record of 10 wins and 2 losses. Training out of United MMA and Evolve MMA, representing the United States of America and Singapore! She is the reigning and defending undisputed one Atomweight champion of the world, unstoppable Angela Lee. And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Justin Brown.
Ladies, center. Championship bout, you both know the rules. I expect you to keep it clean. Obey my commands at all times. Defend yourself at all times. Do not strike the back of the head or the spine. Touch gloves if you want, and please back up.
Final instructions from South Carolina's own Bad Bad Justin Brown.
Listen.
25 minutes for the Atomweight Mixed Martial Arts World Championship. The circle door closes inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium.
Judge ready, timekeeper ready. Round one, let's go.
11:09 p.m. Saturday, March 26, 2022. The collision course we all knew would happen. And they come out two behinds.
Immediately, Angela Lee comes out like she's shot out of a cannon trying to close that distance and get into the clinch with Stamp. This is where Stamp does a lot of good work, utilizing the elbows and the knees, but Angela is not afraid of a firefight.
Angela tremendously strong as Stamp throws the left knee to the breadbasket.
First takedown attempt here by Angela Lee. She's got that headlock. Stamp sneaks out the back. Stamp has got good control inside that clinch. We've seen it time and time again. But this is mixed martial arts. This is a different type of clinch she's going to have to get used to. And also, a different type of grappler in Angela Lee.
Elbow there, Muay Thai style from Stamp. And she backs away, creates some distance for the strikes now. Angela pouring with the lead hand. Stamp jabs. Angela jab, hook.
Not a lot of level changes coming from Lee. She's not really threatening the takedown. She's kind of entering Stamp's wheelhouse here. Here she is popping around the backside. Let's see if she can commit to a takedown here. Stamp's got a good job with that overhook. Right now she's keeping Angela upright. Angela's driving the knees into the thighs of Stamp.
Right in front of the corner, there's her dad, Ken Lee, giving instructions to Angela.
Put your fingers
first up against the fence here. 1.5 minutes down, opening round, set for five. Angela trying to affect the takedown. Stamp maintains her vertical base.
I've been talking to a lot of Stamp's partners this week, and they say she's incredibly hard to take down, and even harder to keep down when she's there. Good disengagement there from Stamp as she lands a right hand.
Stamp's power salvos are coming agonizingly close. Angela again, range finding with that lead hand. Stamp waiting, throws it outside thigh kick. There's a mean look at the kiss on Stamp.
Oh!
Angela's hurt!
Angela's been hurt to the body before. Stamp's jumping on her.
Here it comes! Here it comes! No! Angela survived! But she's hurt! The body's hurt!
Stamp's digging to the body again. She keeps going to it.
Stamp smells blood in the water. Here comes Stamp! The knees are open to the head of the ground and opponent. And Stamp giving it a leg free.
That's a good job by Angela to try to circle around that leg. She's got the single leg in tight. Stamp's got to unload right now. This is giving chance. This is giving Angela a chance to recover.
Is Angela recovered? Double leg now from the queen, from the champion.
Watch but she was in
trouble
eyes.
From the body shots of Stamp Fairtex.
That's how Jung Jin Na was able to stop Angela with those body shots. Stamp found a home early for that shot.
Knees here for Angela Pahak. Kills the right knuckles between the eyes of Stamp. Was it an opportunity gone amiss for Stamp Fairtex? More right hands here from Angela.
Oh, look at the way Angela's controlling the far arm of Stamp. That's high-level grappling right there. What she's doing here is she's buying time to recover. She almost got shut down, but the veteran that she is, she was able to retain the position and recover.
The experience coming through of Angela Lee.
Oh, she got that body lock. Stamp was able to utilize that overhook to really get it. He's over there. He's got the back.
The time is time. Angela on the back. Can she thunder out? Can she sink a choke? Can she strangle Stamp Fairtex? And Stamp looking composed, looking relaxed. And Angela softens her up a little more. Angela grunting behind those strikes.
Look at Angela. So what she's trying to do is she's trying to distract Stamp with the kicks with the heel as she looks for a submission with her right arm. She's trying to get underneath the neck.
How the tide has turned. How the pendulum has swung. Angela, masterful with her submissions. Catches, slip right on Stamp.
I think Angela's trying to go for a possible armbar here. She might transition away as she tries to extend right now.
40 seconds remaining in the first round. Angela was hurt. She looked to be done earlier on, courtesy of the body shots. Now the back of Stamp. The neck is being threatened.
Can she survive 30 seconds, Michael?
And Stamp looks
Angela's locked. Attacking.
Looks unfazed.
That right hand is close to the neck there, as Angela's looking for it. She's got the body triangle now.
Figure four wrapped around the
She's
midsection.
She's a bit high, though. She's a bit high in her positioning. So it's going to be hard to reach down and attack the neck. She's going to have to adjust. She might choose to go after the arm.
And look at Stamp trying to defend, trying to get back to her feet. Angela repositioned. Angela trying to suck her left. What a first round! Both women pump their fists. My word, we've got ourselves a fight dragon.
Oh, yes, we do. It all started with the body shot. Take a look at this. Stamp Fairtex being that accurate striker that she is. Going to the liver. Angela wincing, backpedals. Has to dig deep here. And she was able to get the body lock. And then this transition to the back was a thing of beauty.
Rich Franklin, your thoughts after a captivating 5 minutes.
Let me tell you, Angela did an amazing job with her strategy in that match because that fight was all but over. She was hurt to the body, but she did a good job of clinching with Stamp taking her to the ground. But I'll tell you, I believe that this first 5 minutes has been a moral victory for Stamp because she's been in the worst possible position that Angela could have had her in and survived it.
Second round for the Atomweight Championship of the World, and Angela dances out of the corner. Probing again with that lead hand. Will Stamp go back to the body of the world's champion? She does with a knee.
And Angela gets right back into that clinch, looking to drag Stamp Fairtex back into her world, and that's the mat.
Elbows from Stamp, trying to use the Muay Thai on the inside.
Good use of the underhook right there. Let's see if she can stay upright. Oh, no. A torquing, wrenching takedown from Angela Lee. She ends up in side control. Bad spot for Stamp Fairtex to be in.
This is Angela's world. She cuts the hips in here. And Stamp's going to have to defend. Knees to the head from Angela.
Oh, Stamp's turning the wrong way. She's giving up her back. It's a bad move. She doesn't want to turn her back to Angela like that. She's got to try to go chest to chest and face Angela. But Angela might be forcing the situation here as she might jump on the back again. Yep. And she's got the arm isolated. And she's got that arm trapped.
And there's a long time to go. 355.
Oh, Stamp.
Stamp on top.
Stamp fights her way back up. But look, she's attacking.
Oh, Angela. Kiss together.
Straight arm lock. Transition to a triangle.
Can Angela finish her?
Stamp's got to be careful. She's got to posture up. She's got to get her head out. She doesn't want to stay there. That's a bad spot.
I'm here. I'm here.
Let's go. It's yours, baby.
Crazy seat in the second round.
And she's in her corner, too. She's got Kim Lee right there coaching her through this.
And survival mode for Stan Fairtex.
Look at Angela trying to attack the armbar.
This crowd going crazy in Singapore.
I don't think Stamp's gonna tap. She's gonna have to take a nap. Oh, she gets out. She's almost out. She's gonna push it. Oh, she's almost out, Michael. Angela's barely hanging on to that arm. Look at her trying to push the leg off. Angela's going to
the corner. Turn it down. And Stamp Fairtex got to defend again now. Halfway through this round.
That was a great job of defense, just staying composed and calm. She learned from the Rosalina episode where she tapped prematurely at the end of the round, and she survived. Angela's trying to step over. Stamp's got to work her way back up to her feet. She does not want to tangle with the BJJ black belt on the ground. Angela is just levels ahead of her.
Still a long time to go. 2 minutes remaining. Second round of five for the Atomweight World Championship. And the champ, the queen, Angela Lee in control. In front of her corner with her husband, Bruno Pucci. Her father, Ken Lee, talking her through it. Knees to the ribs now. Stamp going turtle shell. Now up onto her knees. Angela tries to get a hook in.
Stamp's got to defend that right arm. She's got to try to go two on one and pull the arm to the other side, and she does just that. Now she's out of danger. But you know what Angela's doing? She's setting up the twister here. Stamp's got to be very careful. There's the twister coming. She gets that arm around her head. Stamp can't let her left arm get around the neck of Angela because there's a twister.
Here it comes! Here it comes! It's madness!
Let's go, let's go, let's go! Let's go!
Angela is just one step ahead. This is a complete chess match right now. And Angela Lee is the queen's gambit as she's moving through these moves.
Oh, good ground pound. Right to the side of the head there from Angela. And there's a couple of more. Stan Fairtex having to defend for most of the round. Knees to the head of a ground that opponents are leaving. She mounts her. Angela in full mount.
Stamp's defending here. She turns. She goes belly down. Angela's going to try to flatten her out. Angela's got 25 seconds to work. What can the champion pull out of her bag of tricks as he flattens her out?
She's flattening her out.
Rear naked choke.
15 seconds remaining.
Stamp's got to survive.
10 seconds now. And survival. match. This was amazing.
Yeah, it was a methodical move to just keep attacking submission after submission. Stamp did a beautiful job of defending, but it was just one too many. And once Angela Lee gets your neck, flattens out Stamp Fairtex and applies the world championship squeeze, she had to tap it.
What a moment. Let's get a top now, make it all official.
To present the belt for this match, we have the chairman and CEO of One Championship, Mr. Chatri Sichodong. And now, ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Justin Brown, has called a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 50 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of rear naked choke and still undisputed One Atomweight Champion of the World, Angela Lee.
She is still the queen after a 2-year absence. With a performance like that, a comeback performance in every sense of the word. To come back after 2 years, to come back as a mum, to come back from almost being beaten with body shots, and then to tap Stamp Fairtex out. Ken Lee, her father. Bruno Pucci, her husband. Jewel Lee, her mother, is here, no doubt, on babysitting duties with her granddaughter, Ava Marie, who is also in Singapore. Christian, Adrian, Victoria, all back home in Hawaii and watching. One more look at the epic ending. Let's go to the dragon now. Get the queen.
And still, champion of the world, Angela Lee. How's that sound?
That sounds about right. Hey guys, thank you so much for showing up. What's up, Singapore? I miss you guys. Oh, there she is. Oh my God. Mama Dini, look at you, huh? Sorry.
You said coming into this fight that your why was different, and we clearly see that. Tell us a little bit about it.
Guys, this moment right here is a dream come true for me. You know, I wanted to be a world champion, and I accomplished that in 2016. And today, March 26th, 2022, I became the first ever mom champ in One Championship. Yeah! Look at that! Look at that! And, you know, this little girl right here, she's the reason that you guys saw just the best performance from me, you know? I trained just harder than ever, pushed myself more than ever. And because of her, because of my amazing team, United MMA, United BJJ, I grew and I've, you know, transformed into this world champion that you see today. So thank you, Ava Marie. Mama did it for you, baby girl.
Well, I gotta ask, it looks like you were in a lot of trouble in that first round with that body shot, but we can clearly see that you had a whole different reason to keep going.
You know what? That body shot hurt, but I can tell you that my contractions that I was having when I was in labor hurt more than that, but I gotta give credit to Stamp, you know? I love her, she's amazing. I love her so much that I avoided her this fight week because I knew if I saw her, I was gonna give her a hug. And you guys saw yesterday, we were taking selfies with each other, and she's an amazing person, you know? She trains hard, and to do what we do at the highest level, you have good days, and you have harder days, you know? But with my team, you know, we work so hard so that we can power through when the days are tough, and that's what you saw in the first and second round.
you managed to change gears and you really started to put together a lot of different submissions. At what point did you know it was done?
You know what? I just keep fighting until the very, very end. So I knew I had it. I was close to finishing and I didn't want to chance it. You know, I fought until the very end, squeezed it, held it, and was able to get the finish at the very end of round two.
Well, what's the message for your friends, your family, and your fans all around the world?
I love you guys. Seriously, thank you, thank you, thank you. Mahalo, obrigada. And I just, guys, everyone around the world who stayed up to watch the fight, thank you, I appreciate it, all the messages. I've seen them, sorry if I can't reply, but I feel the love and support, and it feels good to be back.
Well, not only do you get that shiny new belt, but Chachri Sigyatong has also given you a $50,000 bonus to celebrate your victory.
That's Ava's college tuition. Woo!
Ladies and gentlemen, show your love to unstoppable Angela Lee!
So much love. What a way to end 1X. An amazing performance for Angela Lee to come back after looking almost out of it from the body shot of Stamp Fairtex. To then unleash her entire repertoire. And she hoists Ava Marie on her shoulders. The first ever one money champion. Her reason for why is right there. Amazing. Amazing scenes. One of the greatest nights, if not the greatest, we have ever seen. Let's take you through 1X one more time. It kicked off with Superbon defending the featherweight kickboxing world title against Mara Gregorian. This was excellence all the way, every round over five. Superbon won, dismantling Gregorian. Next up, John Wayne Parr, final fight. The going was very tough for Wayne in the first two rounds. He got knocked down by Edward Flyhang. But then somehow, in the third round, after getting knocked down here, Wayne Parr rallied back, and he almost knocked down Edward Flyhang. It was the third round for the ages. We shall not soon forget, he said farewell to a legend, John Wayne Parr. Then in what was maybe the fight of the night, the next one, Akiyama Aoki. Aoki looked to have Akiyama's measure, put the backpack on him early. But then somehow, Sexyama came back and he bludgeoned Aoki. Look at Aoki's face here as he takes punishment and pritched through it. Akiyama brought the house down. Then, Yuna Wakamatsu, Adriana Moraes. Wakamatsu made a cardinal error. Why would you shoot in on a takedown against a world champion and a BJJ black belt of the highest order? You'll see it in a moment. It was the beginning of the end for Yuya Wakamatsu. Shoots in, gets caught, taps out. Then the super fight. The whole world had waited for. Rodtang and Demetrious Johnson. Rodtang, first round, Muay Thai, brought it to Demetrious, and so too did DJ. And he hit Rodtang with some amazing shots. He survived the first 3 minutes. Then we went into the mixed martial arts round and Rodtang would not tap. So DJ went to sleep. After that, we came to our main event, as you just saw. The darling, Stamp Fairtex, the Queen Angela Lee. Stamp almost had Angela, but she injured her with a body shot there. Angela was recoiling. Stamp almost had her, almost finished her. Somehow Angela survived, got her to the ground, did what Angela does. Every trick in the book imaginable. Tried to twist her, tried to belly down, armbar. Eventually, strangled her. Tap out. The Queen reigned supreme. It was an epic night. It was history made. It was the biggest the most ambitious martial arts show of all time, and we did it. And we thank you for joining us. On behalf of everyone at ONE Championship, thank you. Congratulations to all of our athletes. Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chilson, Rich Franklin saying good night.